The year was 1980. It was the last time the Hershey Bears raised the Calder Cup at home, hoisted in the old Hershey Park Arena. Since then, Hershey has won four more Calder Cups, but all on the road. Tonight, a sellout crowd will welcome home the Bears for a possible Calder Cup celebration. But the Texas Stars hope to spoil the party. It's Texas and Hershey, Game 6, next. Tonight from Giant Center in Hershey, Pennsylvania, ABC 27 Sports brings you Game 6 of the American Hockey League Calder Cup Finals as the Texas Stars meet the Hershey Bears, presented by Capital Blue Cross. Hi again, everybody. I'm Greg Mace, together with the voice of the Bears, John Walton and Ed Coffey. John, what a trip it was for the Hershey Bears after leaving here, two games to none, being down to the Texas Stars, won three in a row. What do they have to do to keep that momentum going?
Well, the first 10 minutes, Greg, are key. If you think about what this team's done at home this season, the 24 straight wins, the greatest home ice season that the American Hockey League has ever seen, it starts with crooked numbers in the first period. For the Bears to be successful, they need to come out. This crowd is going to be electric tonight. Feed off the energy of the crowd, but keep their composure. There's a fine balance that has to be struck there. If they do that and they score early, could be a good night here in Chocolate Town tonight.
So, Ed, from a player's perspective, what does it take to keep that focus? Because, as John said, the crowd's going to be in a frenzy tonight.
Well, John hit a point when he said it's the first 10 minutes and all the things that you have to do as a team. Now what you have to do as an individual is you're waiting to get your first touch. That includes the players on the ice and the goaltender. As soon as you get your first touch, remember, these are professionals, and then they are ready to go. So all the pregame jitters are gone once you hop over the bench.
All right, we welcome all of you watching tonight on ABC 27 as well as Comcast Sportsnet and NHL Network. We're back with the opening faceoff coming up. It's Texas and Hershey, Game 6 of the Calder Cup Finals, next. Standing room only, sellout crowd at Giant Center with the national anthem, and now they will be pumped up even more. Lamont Buford, known as Puckhead, you're going to see him. A long-standing tradition here at Giant Center. Lamont was with us for many, many years. Went to the National Hockey League, but they bring him back for special occasions. Now watch and listen. Here is Puckhead.
Some noise in here! Let's go, Bears!
The crowd is on their feet. Game 6 Calder Cup Finals. The Hershey Bears need one win for a second straight Calder Cup. This is the last professional hockey playoff series in North America. And here we go, the Bears have a chance to win their first cup at home since 1980. Carl Alsner is set, so is our play-by-play team, Ed Coffey, and the voice of the Bears, John Walton.
Well, thank you, Greg. As we come to center ice, you see Carl Alsner and Keith Acoin steps in. Game 6 of the Calder Cup Final as we are here at Giant Center and underway, the puck back into the Bears zone. John Carlson starting with the Bears. This building as loud as perhaps we have ever heard it. Not an empty seat to be had, 11,000 strong watching Game 6 and the chance for the hometown Hershey Bears to win their 11th Calder Cup Championship. Jamie Benn in for Texas and a shot that comes off the length pad of Michael Neuwirth. Along the near side, Jancevski with a shot. This one comes in on Neuwirth as well and will dribble to the wall. Along the near wing, Andrew Gordon. But a lead pass ahead to Chris Bork. He is ridden off the puck by Jamie Benn. Bears get an early line change here at Giant Center in Game 6. A couple of shots for Texas for openers. And the Stars beginning behind their net with defenseman Matt Stevenson. Stevenson logging a lot of time, especially in the absence of Andrew Hutchinson, out due to injury as an early icing call here. Again, back in front of Brent Cron. 53 seconds into the game, and a faceoff back in front of the Texas goaltender. Time for our Faulkner Honda keys to the game. Ed Coffey, bring you in here. The first 10 minutes of the game, obviously very important. This crowd feeding on what the Bears do on the ice. The best guys obviously needing to play their best. Brent Cron turned into a bit of a wild card for us here tonight. Didn't expect to see that.
Who would have thought? And of course, you never second guess an opposing coach on what he wants to do. Wants to shake up his team a little bit after three consecutive losses at home. Cron, big 6'5" goaltender. Very, very agile, though, belies his size.
He has been out of the lineup for 36 days due to injury. He returns tonight for Texas here in Game 6. Peters with a puck brought up along the left wing side. He will circle the wagon, shoot it in toward Neuwirth, and it stops short on deflection on Patrick Weller. Weller chasing it off to the far side, and now the puck again along the near wing. It is Matthew Perreault, end over end with a puck to center. The Bears carry it along, sending it back in wide of Brent Cron. Jay Beagle from behind the net again along the near wing, and a puck that floats out to center and beyond. Icing will be waved off here as the Bears back in their own zone. The Stars get a line change, just over a minute and a half gone by. This crowd, a buzz of what they are hoping to see here tonight. Cody Eakin out of Swift Current in juniors. He brings it down the wall and into the left wing corner for Francois Bouchard. Eakin as a rookie, born in 1991. This is all new to him. The puck along the near side, but stepping right in there and doing a pretty good job. He has been in the lineup three games in a row now. Patty McNeil sent it far side. Greg Rallo, number 27 for Texas, on the intercept as he looks to send it in. And now Michael Neuwirth from behind the net will make the stop. They still haven't gotten that shot on goal that they're looking for early on. Puck ahead to the middle. And Ludwig brings it back to the Texas line, and a chip that comes up the dasher board. Bears fighting for the puck. Bouchard with a clear. Beaudoin will take over. 2.5 minutes deep into the first period. The remainder of hockey in North America professionally will end here in Hershey this week. It could end tonight. It will definitely be over by Wednesday. That's when Game 7 would be. Along the left wing, now Jodry in and a shot. Cron, Beagle, the rebound, and the net comes off. The puck came from the right circle, and good puck movement. Brent Cron run into. Helmet comes off. Net comes off as well. And a discussion with the referee, Frederick Leguier.
Well, this is exactly what you want to see the Bears start doing. They're going to the net. They're getting through the neutral zone very quickly, John. As you can see, Jodry comes in, pushes it across. Cron has a little bit of trouble with the rebound as he can't get it away from him or hold it. And the Bears are in there with Kane, who's forcing the play and goes right into the net.
Now, Boyd Kane did a pretty good job right there of crashing in. The Bears, pretty decent scoring chance. Brent Cron rights himself. As a Bear ran into the post last, they will move the faceoff out of the zone, won by Texas. And it is cleared across Trevor Ludwig, the twin brother of Tyler, who is not in the lineup tonight. It is sent in along the right side. And Greg Amadio, number 32, you were with us in Game 5. He took a puck right in the nose in the second period and was back before the period even came to a close. That's how tough this guy is. Back in behind the Texas net. Stars work to the right wing and a pass ahead through Garrett Stafford and again back into the Bears zone. Touched up here for an icing call. Bring it back in front of Cron with 16:43 to go in the first period. That shot from Kane, officially the first for the Bears. It is their only shot here in the early going.
Well, here's what the Bears are doing. They're playing this very intelligently, trying to solve the Stars and get in deep. The Stars are going back into that collapse that they've been able to really do a good job with the entire series. But the Bears are getting it back to their points, and they're taking their shots and getting the puck into deep in the Stars zone and then going in for those rebounds.
McCullough fanned on the attempt in. The Bears will circle with John Carlson. This pairing of Carlson and Alsner, you can expect to see these guys in red, white, and blue next year for the Washington Capitals. Back in, and Alsner another touch for an icing call. Ed, we have seen up close and personal, and this is what the American Hockey League is all about. It is the final stop before the National Hockey League. And for number 7 and number 4, Carl Alsner and John Carlson, if the Bears win tonight, this will be the last we probably ever see them here.
Absolutely. They proved themselves at both levels during the season. As a matter of fact, playing with each other, did a fantastic job at both levels.
You see the referee and linesman there. Frederick Lecuyer is the referee tonight. Bob Goodman and Brian Pancich are the linesmen, as Andrew Gordon carries the puck in right wing side. A little bit of room to move, and a shot that goes wide. Back along the wall board. Dings it out. Port, the leading point getter in the series. A shot from Carlson that rings in from the right side. And Texas able to take the rebound and will bounce it up along the far side. Good chances as the Bears start to find their legs in the offensive zone in the early stages of Game 6. The shots are even at 2. And a puck that is carried in. Alsner slotting it in wide of the goal. And just on the other side of the red line, that will be whistled down. And an icing call here. Bring the draw back in front of Neuvert with 15:38 to go in the first. And Ed, you yourself as a former goaltender, Michael Neuvert, this is another guy. When you talk about Alsner and Carlson and guys that are likely to be up top, what we've seen out of Michael this year, he's been fantastic.
And it's not just physically, John. It's mentally also. He does not get rattled. I don't know what he has going through his veins, but it's got to be a little bit colder than ice water. Never seems to be panicking. Always seems to have that confidence.
A faceoff won by Texas. Ray Sawada with a puck behind the net. And around the near side, Alsner will make the stop and find Carlson far side of the goal, shooting it through the trapezoid. And now Bork with a pass ahead to Jay Beagle. Jay Beagle has been terrific for Hershey, especially the games in Texas. Game 4, he had the tying goal and was brilliant otherwise, especially along the wall. Big, strong. The touch up here, another icing call. Kind of get the feeling here with not quite 5 minutes gone for Hershey. A little bit of nerves perhaps in front of 11,000 votes despite their great success in Texas. And for the Stars, you make an argument, this is kind of what they're looking for. You can kind of withstand the first 10 minutes. You're scoreless, you're getting shots. Try and take the crowd out of it a little bit. This is big for Texas right now.
Oh, you're hitting the nail on the head. They're playing it very cagey. They're doing that neutral zone trap. They get their players back. Maybe one forechecking forward that's staying around the faceoff circle.
The puck won here and then shot wide as it came in from the blue line by Patrick McNeil. The Ontario native will send it along the near wall. Matthew Perreault will dig it out. Perreault with time in Washington this year as well. A shot from McNeil coming in on Cron. And a save as it comes off the pads. And from the pillows to the wall, the Bears will take it again. Now on the left side for Perreault. Shaded by two Texas defenders there. Peters in to help out, and the puck stays in. There's hustle after it, left circle. Beagle centers, lifted stick in front. Alexander Giroux, the hero of Game 5 with that overtime winner against Matt Climie. No shot attempt for him here as it is cleared away. Both teams changing as we approach 6 minutes gone here in this first period, Game 6 of the 2010 Calder Cup Finals. The Bears, a couple of shots. Texas, likewise, nothing. Here at Giant Center in Hershey. Along the near side, Cody Eakin. Brought back through Morant, kept in by Ludwig. Looking to hammer it around the wall, but too hard for Greg Rallo behind the net. On the right wing for Bouchard, he's unable to get it out. Now loose in front for Landon Wilson. Over his stick as it goes to the far wing. Texas, a nice play to keep it in far side by Garrett Stafford. And a puck for Carlson as it's sent around the wing to Cody Eakin. The Bears forward with legs underneath him and moving out to center. Out as far as the red line, battling all the while. The defender in Travis Morin, Texas, taking over the biscuit in their own zone. A clearing attempt denied. Wilson with a drive in front, and it's turned away by Cron. Still loose and a bouncing puck going wide of the goal. Now on the right wing side, go ahead is Kyle Wilson getting hit off the puck, and Morin with a clearing attempt out to center. Greg Rallo firing this one in well wide of the Hershey net. Ricocheting off the window to Carlson. It's sent far side to Alsner. Bears from their own end. Carlson pressured heavily. Bears beat the pressure out to center. Eakin with a pass left side. It's carried in by Francois Bouchard. He's had a couple of big goals in his series. Back on the right wing, and now for Jodry. Really, when you get to this stage, they're all big goals. So along the near side, Pinizzato, as he moves it in on the right wing board, McCullough able to hit him just hard enough to get the puck, and then it's carried in far wing by ex-Bear Matthew Beaudoin. Beaudoin far wing, he was terrific as well in Game 5 as this shot comes in on Michael Neuvert. Physical presence Beaudoin was on the wall at Cedar Park Center outside of Austin, Texas. The puck for Jancevski along the near wing and then edging it back into the Texas zone. The Stars with a pass ahead off of Beaudoin and back into the Bears' end. No icing here. as the stars will change. Amadio will start from behind his own net. A battle of possession. And as it's moved in here left side, Pinizzato feeds up top. Carlson across to Walsner, a one-timer that's tipped wide of the goal. And a coin looking to follow it in. Carlson along the left wing board, following a loose puck. Here's with pressure, a coin getting into the right circle. A shot and a good deflection by Maxime Fortunas as he put it to the right wing corner. Now Pinizzato from behind the net, board for the one-timer! And off the leg pad of Cron, it comes to the wall. Terrific opportunity for the AHL's leading playoff scorer, Chris Bourque. Texas getting set from behind the net. Jamie Benn turned it over, loose for Bourque, and a shot that goes wide. Jamie Benn, the NHLer from Dallas all season, a turnover in front. Chris Bourque almost made him pay for it. This crowd going crazy, Ed.
Well, Chris Bourque just stripping that puck and coming in with a great chance, but couldn't quite get a handle on the puck, and the shot goes wide. Cron does not look a little rusty right now, as he's able to handle another shot from right in front on a tip.
The shot from Bourque, covered by Cron, will take a timeout. 11:24 to go in the first. Nothing here in Game 6. You're watching the 2010 Calder Cup Finals. With early pressure here, the shots are 6-3 in favor of the home team. And the crowd here jumping up and down. Even when there is downtime, it seems like there's none for this crowd here tonight, Ed.
Oh, this is so loud here. You can feel the actual vibrations as the fans are roaring their approval with every turn. The Bears are giving them a lot to roar about so far, John. Really penetrating star zones. They're getting a bunch of scoring chances, too.
A little bit of handiwork from the linesman, Brian Pancich, there. As the faceoff coming to the right of Brent Cron, scoreless midway through the first here in Game 6. The Bears trying to win a Calder Cup tonight. Texas trying to force a Game 7 on Wednesday night here at 7 o'clock Eastern. On the right side for Helmer as it is tipped to the slot. Perreault picks up the puck against Ludwig and a centering try right through the blue paint and back along the right side for Helmer. Right wing corner and a hit put on by Wathier. The Bears maintain possession in the offensive zone. It's Perreault from the high slot behind the net to Beagle and loose to the side of the net, picked up by Alexander Giroux. Texas having trouble clearing it out, and the Bears trying to get some more pucks on the Texas backstop. Along the near side, Giroux takes the puck, right circle, a shot in front. Cron tried to cover and couldn't. McNeil turns and fires it wide. Perreault with a try in front, and it comes out of the zone. Texas just able to get it down ice, and they need a line change out in a bad way.
Well, I'm telling you, right now, the only thing that's keeping them in the game at this early part of the first period is Brent Cron, who's playing his first game in a long time, not showing any signs of his injury.
The puck along the right wing for Wilson, and a whistle and a hand pass called here with 10:17 left in the first period. The Bears have gotten 6 shots unanswered against Brent Cron now, as the puck came in on the Texas goaltender. Just winning battles in the one-on-one battles. You see one there with Peters, that Giroux just picks it up and turns around. That's the key, Ed, one-on-one battles. Coach is talking about it.
And if you notice, Giroux was able to walk in, which they have not been able to do. The Bears have not been able to really do that for most of the series right now because of that collapse that the Stars employ.
The puck sent along the wall, and now it comes back into the Texas zone. It's Bouchard at the side of the net. Along the near wing, Bouchard picks it up, sends it across the blue line. John Carlson is there, a shot as it comes in, and a rattler off the backside and into the right wing corner. The Bears, very, very good pressure here early. After Carlson picked it up right point, he'll send it down the wall to Bouchard. Texas able to get sticks in the way. Landon Wilson is able to edge that one out. Texas changing. Short shifts for Texas here. They need them so far.
Well, both teams want to do that to get their players to get as many touches as possible and get rid of whatever nerves are still left after the first couple of shifts, which should be ended now. But the problem for Texas is that the Bears aren't letting them get through the neutral zone coming into their zone, and they can't get the Bears out of their zone once the Bears get possession.
Bears in their own end now. And a hit that Amadio takes from McCullough, the puck continuing on, and it neutralized Boyd Kane. He one of 8 different overtime goal scorers for Hershey this playoff year. 8 OT winners, extending an American Hockey League record. The Bears did that Friday night in Cedar Park. Puck across now to Carlson. A shot here in front and a save made as Brent Prod holds on to it. 8:51 to go here in the first. No score at Giant Center in Hershey. You're watching the 2010 Calder Cup Finals. Group going up against Texas. For Texas to come here and win those two games at Giant Center were huge. But the task may be bigger now for the Stars in trying to win a 6-7.
Well, you look at the way this game started. It was 8:51 to go in the first period. Bears out shooting the Stars 10-3 and really dominating play thus far.
Cron is ready for the draw to his left. Key the coin, taking it for Hershey. Chris Bork in this series joining this line, bumping out Alexander Giroux to line two. And it has worked very well here against Texas. With a puck brought back by the Stars, Colton Sevier from behind the net going right wing side. Kept in by Stevenson at the right point. He brings it down the wall. Now on the right side, Jamie Benn. Puck into the dot, taken here by Carlson. And around the wall near side, the Bears try to move and will. A coin with a lead pass to Bork. For a coin again across the Texas line. Moving to Gordon, a shot blocked down and picked up by Stevenson. In behind the goal for Chris Bork. Bork called down and a penalty coming out. Darren Gagnon is going to go as the puck is touched up by Texas with 8:11 to go in the first period. The game scoreless, but a power play now for the Hershey Bears here at home. And the Bears pretty good in this department with the guys that they've got.
Yeah, Aaron Gagnon with a pursuit penalty. He hauls Bork down, and now you've got this A-team that's out there right now on the power play to move the puck around and get their first power play chance of the game.
Aaron Gagnon, the two-minute minor, and a faceoff coming up in front of Cron. A high stick is the official call on number 11 in the green, gold, and black. And a puck in behind the goal for a coin as it moves to the left wing side. Hershey trying to strike first here in game six. As the puck sent to Giroux, far side, off the wall, the coin takes it, puts it in front. Gordon with a try, and it comes away to the right wing side. Hustling after it is Bork. He will keep it in the zone. On the right board, over the stick of a coin. Here's trying to settle it down. Pressure on a coin on the wall. Carlson into the left circle. And the Bears trying to find something as Bork from the left point brings it in. It's four forwards and one D. Carlson the only D. Giroux with a shot. Rebounding for the score! John Carlson on the rebound! And the Bears 1-0 leaders here in game six.
Giroux is back in the slot, waits for that pass to come out, where he likes to set up his housekeeping. It is sent out from beyond the faceoff circle. He takes that one-timer. John Carlson had already come in to get ready for the backdoor play. As Cron lets that rebound go, Carlson is there to pop it in. It goes right by him. Bears 1-0.
For John Carlson, it is just his second goal. They've both come here in the finals. And as he comes to center with Alsner, the guy that is referred to in some circles in D.C. as Captain America, the game-winning goal at World Juniors in Saskatoon in early January in overtime, gets this game going tonight for Hershey, a 1-0 leader in game six. And for the Bears, head now out shooting the Stars 13-3. Meaning that they have had 11 shots to Texas zero since it was a couple of shots on the board for the Stars to begin things here.
Well, they've been playing extremely aggressive. They're going in with two men on that forecheck. They're playing really a great game down low, moving that puck around. I think the difference between this and previous games is that they've learned to be a lot more patient. They're taking care of the perimeter right now when the Stars won't give them the middle.
Carl Alsner behind the goal. John Carlson gets it going. The Bears here scoring first in what could be a deciding game if Hershey wins it. 1-0 Bears here in the first period. Matthew Perreault behind the net. In and out of the trapezoid. Wrapper on try Baudois is decked by Carlson as that play ends. And Michael Neuwirth able to cover it up. Giving Michael Neuwirth the lead, Ed, more often than not, is tough for the opposition. He's got a slim lead to work with now here in the first period.
Well, he's very, very calm in the net. Really likes to take control of the game and good down low. On that wraparound, you saw that it was a tough play for him to get over, where he was on the other side looking for the play and had to move over extremely quickly as Bedlois came around the net, was able to hold on to it.
To the right of Michael Neubert. With 6:47 to play in the first period, Hershey leading in the series, 3-2, leading game six, 1-0 here at Giant Center. And a puck along the near wing for Peters. And getting reset, Andrew Jodry gonna get tossed out now in favor of Boyd Kane. And a puck, one back to Graham. Ethan Graham toward Wapier in the corner, slapped away here by McNeil. And a puck that comes to the red line. Jodry gets it off the dasher board. He'll find Boyd Kane at center. Kane with a dump in. It is carried in now by Ray Sawada. Sawada with a clear for Texas. Right wing, Helmer behind the net, up on the wing for Kane. Here's with a lot of pressure. Texas at their best in this series. Good at trapping at the Hershey blue line and trying to take advantage of whatever opportunities would come their way. Here, they come in offside, so no opportunity to be had. 6:20 to go here in the first.
You're seeing a big difference now in the Stars forecheck. They just went with what's called the 2-1-2. They sent two men in deep, try and force the play. One man will take the body, the other man will take the puck to try and pin the Bears back into the zone. So they're mixing up that trap where they're not being very aggressive at all with sending in two men and really trying to get something going in the Bears zone and trying to figure out what's different in this game that hasn't been happening in the previous games.
The draw to happen here short of the Texas, or the Hershey blue line, rather. And as it is one, Jodry just edging it back. Little help from Pinizzato. Carlson will start things here for the guys in chocolate, gray, and white. It is sent far side to Walzer, and then on into the Texas zone. Too far, in fact. Icing will be the call. 6:08 to go in the first period. Texas, they certainly didn't want to give up the first goal. They certainly didn't want to get outshot 13-4. The first 4 or 5 minutes looked to be maybe, okay, this is going Texas's way, but it hasn't been since then. They've got to find a way to get it turned around a little bit.
No, the Bears are sticking and moving. Once they get into that that attack zone, they're making their passes, and they're not standing around to admire them. They're moving around, and that's what's throwing Texas off, is that being able to work high and low.
Kane carries it in for Hershey. A shot high and wide, but not by much. Rattling off the window, left side to Walser. And now to Pinizzato behind the net. Stars on the wall, cannot clear. Bears doing a great job of holding the offensive zone in this first period. Carlson, a pass now to Kane in front, through the crease, off front, and shot, they score! Carlson! 2-0 Hershey!
Also standing over at the side of the net, just watching and being very, very patient as he stays at his point, moves up, waits for the puck to come along, goes onto that left face-off circle as he knows it's safe to come down, not worried about the puck breaking out again, lets the puck go, and it beats Cron short side.
That was a beautiful shot from Alstner. And the guys we were talking about in the open, if it is going to be, Ed, their final game, what a way for it to start for Alstner and Carlson here in game six.
Well, they make sure that their stay will have been memorable, John. I don't think anybody can argue that.
John Carlson is known as the guy, the wheeler dealer up front, and Alstner staying at home. However you look at it, they're both on the board. Carlson up first, Alstner does it second. Hershey on a 14-4 shot run. They lead it 2-0 here in game six. Carlson gets a helper. He's had a two-point night. Boyd Kane getting an assist as well. And the Stars have got to be reeling a little bit now, and the pressure for the visitors from the Lone Star State starting to mount. The puck for Rallo along the right wing and for Gordon at center. Andrew Gordon with a shot in on net. And now for Patrick Weller along the right wing. Gordon left wing corner. And from behind the net is Gordon held up. Battling through a check. The Stars fighting for every inch behind the net, but they still cannot clear it. A coin with a shot and knocked down. And a puck's into the far side. Weller with a shot going wide and coming into the right wing corner. Now for Amadio as it comes up against Rallo. And for Gordon in the right wing corner. Greg Amadio coming after the puck. The Bears all over him. A shot from Bourque going wide. And a puck brought to a coin right wing. Texas having all kinds of trouble as it is brought to the near wing. Keith the coin. Far side. And Maxime Fortunas is there. Bears are everywhere right now.
And they're playing very, very intelligently. They're making sure that they're not pinching when they don't have to pinch from the defense. They're not taking any chances. They're staying in position. They're letting the forwards really do the bulk of the job inside the star zone once they get in there. And the points are staying back as long as they can.
Jay Beagle brings it in now for Hershey. The Bears a 2-0 leader here in Game 6, trying to win the Calder Cup tonight. Back in behind the net to the right wing. Perreault on the right wing side, finding Giroux, and he'll roll it back to the far side. Alsner is there. John Carlson first. Then it was Carl Alsner. The defense gets it going for Hershey here in Game 6. With a puck along the wall. Baudouin with a touch here, trying to clear and cannot. Texas just cannot clear their zone at all. They're getting outshot 16-4 now as Carlson moves it to the right point, bringing it on across. And a puck in front toward Kronz, still loose in front and brought along the far side. Now a shot from Beagle coming in. A wraparound try thrown out in front as Kronz went down. It comes out of the zone, but it's going to be an icing call on Texas. Listen to this crowd. Going crazy in Chocolate Town with 2:38 to go in the first period. All kinds of pressure, Ed, here in the zone.
Well, the pressure is just unbelievable as they break through. Jay Beagle is a whirling dervish in front of the net. He gets a shot in front of the net, follows up his own rebound, and gets it back and tries to wrap around. And all the Stars can do is get it out of the zone, and they send it down to the other end past Michael Neubert for an icing.
Brent Kron looking a little tired at this point.
Yeah,
he's taking a helmet off.
He's exhausted as both teams come to the bench right now. And I think Coach Gullitson on the Stars is figuring, what does he have to do to solve this?
Timeout called here by Texas. With his team being outshot 17-4, and here's a guy that hasn't played in 36 days. This is not the welcome he was hoping for.
No, Gullitson, a very, very good goalie. First round draft pick by Calgary in 2000, 6'5". Covers an awful lot of net, extremely agile. For a big man, he moves really, really well. But, you know, he hasn't played a game in a while, John, and you go through practice and you know you're ready physically and you think you're ready mentally, but playing a game is a lot different than playing in practice, and he's doing a great job so far. He's made some big saves and tried to keep his team in the game, but he's getting peppered.
I don't think whether it's Matt Climie or whether it's Brent Kron, it matters a whole lot if you're getting outshot 17-4.
Absolutely.
Bourque with a shot here off the draw. The Bears have struck twice. They lead it 2-0 here in Game 6. But cleared back in front of Michael Neubert. He has not had to work too hard here in this first period. Carried on now to center as this crowd continues to rev up. Gordon's shot is covered down by Jensevsky and sent to the far wing. Gordon from behind the net. And now Ray Sawada with a takeover for the Texas Stars. The top affiliate of the Dallas Stars, the top affiliate of the Washington Capitals. That is your Calder Cup final here in the American Hockey League in 2010. He's Ed Coffey. I'm John Walton. The broadcast team of the Hershey Bears during the regular season. A puck along the near side here for Sawada. It has been a terrific six-gamer up till now. The Bears have not won a game on home ice here in this series. Despite having a lead, a whistle now with a minute 48 to go in the first period. As we take a timeout, the Bears catch their breath and so will we. John Carlson scoring for Hershey. Carl Alsner adds one next. 2-0 Bears. You're watching the 2010 Calder Cup Finals. Pennsylvania tonight, 2-0. Bears with a lead in Game 6. A shot right off the draw from Maxime Fortunas. That goes wide of the goal. Now for Jamie Benn in front. Knocked down by John Carlson. Carlson got the game's first goal tonight. Two goals in the finals for John Carlson. A game winner on Wednesday night in Game 4. And the first goal here tonight and what the Bears hope will be a decider in game six. The puck along the wall and Jamie Benn fighting his way through on the left side. Andrew Jodery sends it to the wall. Alsner trying to lift it up. Cut off of the pass by Maxime Fortunas. Bears with some possession for Texas in front. A shot coming here from Gagnon. And then Graham with a follow-up that goes wide of the goal. Texas, a rarity here in this period. Some pressure in front of Michael Neuwehr. But with a minute to go here in the first period, just at the announcement from public address announcer Don Scott here at Giants Center, this place going crazy all over again. Texas coming out of their zone with Travis Morin. Morin to the right wing board, or left wing rather, to Rallows. It's sent in, and Helmer will chase. Right now, his partner in Alsner sent to Helmer. Hershey's captain last year as the Bears were Calder Cup champions with a six-game win in the finals over Manitoba. Stevenson with a touch here as the Bears ice it with 30.4 to go in the first period. And a whistle back in front of Michael Neuwehr following the icing call and a brief discussion here that Kyle Wilson wants to have with the linesman.
Yeah, looks like during that icing, you had two people going for it. Might have been touched on the way in, or at least that's what might have been what the Bears thought as they went after the puck behind the net of Brent Cron.
You saw Steve Pinizzato come flying through there on Jamie Benn. Steve Pinizzato and Bruce Boudreau, the coach of the Capitals, joining us here in the radio booth in the last series. There's a very good possibility you could see him as a fourth line type guy. He's going to get a pretty good look at camp in September with Washington, and it's going to be for defense, playing with snarl, and occasionally plays like you see right there against Jamie Benn.
Well, he's that character player whose legs never stop moving, John.
Proud guy out of RIT. And got a chance to get back when the Bears are playing the Americans to talk to his team as they went to the Final Four, the Tigers did for the first time. But cleared away and back now into the Hershey zone. And the final seconds ticking off. And I think it's pretty safe to say they approve of what they see here at Giants Center.
Well, the first period, Bears outshooting the Stars 17-4, outscoring the Stars 2-0, really exploiting that red zone inside the blue line of the Dallas Stars, getting a lot of slot shots, which is something that the Stars really have prided themselves on being able to stop throughout the season and in the playoffs.
Scott McCullough there getting a little bit agitated at someone. You see a shot of the crowd here at Giants Center. A place that has seen a lot of history, but has never seen a Calder Cup raised for either team. Right now, let's go downstairs. Our Greg Mace is standing by with Brian Helmer.
Brian, talk about the offensive pressure you put on, because obviously you wanted to come out strong and you're doing it.
Yeah, that's one thing we talk about before the game is get it behind their D and then use our speed and get the puck to the net and just shoot everything and get rebounds, and it's worked out so far.
Crowd is in a frenzy here.
It's unbelievable. It gives you goosebumps, but there's still two more periods and a lot of work left to do.
They're a tough team. You guys cannot lay back now, obviously.
No, not at all. We just got to keep doing what we're doing and take one shift at a time and just keep throwing the pucks on net and hopefully get a couple more.
All right, Brian, thanks.
Thanks, Greg.
All right, Brian Helmer, captain of the Hershey Bears. He's headed to the locker room. Fans are getting set for a little intermission here. This first period has been sponsored by Faulkner Honda, by Capital Blue Cross, and by 2010 Calder Cup Finals, Game 6 from Giants Center. The place is sold out. Tonight's game presented by Capital Blue Cross. So what a great start for the Hershey Bears, putting a whole lot of pressure on the Texas Stars and doing what they set out to do here in this first period with a 2-0 lead. Well, as you can see by the atmosphere here tonight, it is beyond anything we've ever seen here at Giants Center. Sure, we've had sellout crowds, but never worked into the frenzy that this crowd is tonight. There's been a lot of buildup as the Bears go for their 11th Calder Cup, which is not surprising based on Bears history, as our Ann Mercogliano explains.
Hershey may be best known for its chocolate and park, but last week the lines weren't for candy and coasters, they were for hockey. Hundreds lined up earlier in the week to buy tickets to the Hershey Bears playoff game Monday night. And now the Bears are on the verge of what may be their 11th Calder Cup win. They have unprecedented fan support, averaging nearly 10,000 a game. That's tops in the American Hockey League, and the players say it means everything.
The fans are here so often, and there's so many of them. They get to know you personally, and you sort of build a relationship with a lot of the people in the building.
There's even a restaurant called the Bears Den. As you make your way in, Hershey Bears history comes alive.
Manager Ted Keller says he's hoping to pack the place Monday night.
They've been so successful, so I think that has a lot to do with what we do here.
The community says the team and its history means more than just wins and losses. The team is proud of their Hall of Famers, like the legendary Frank Mathers. Hockey players may not be as recognizable as football or baseball players, but that doesn't seem to be the case in this town.
In other AHL cities, you go into a grocery store and people don't even know who you are. And here, you go into any grocery store and people pick you out, you know, and people love their hockey here. And they support the team really well.
Heart. They got a lot of heart. You've seen it big time this year. I mean, the way they've played from behind at times and the way they bounce back. And same thing with the hospitality around here. We got a big heart.
The Hershey Bears are the 2009 Calder Cup champions.
Monday night, the fans and the Bears hope to make history once again. In Hershey, Ann Mercogliano, ABC 27 News.
Well, we know they are well on their way at this point, the Bears with a 2-0 advantage. We know a lot of folks watching over the Bears Den tonight. People waited in line for hours to get tickets. They went in 3.5 hours. Bears fans are hoping they don't have to go back in line for game number 7. A great crowd here tonight. Well, we want to remind you that you can own your own piece of American Hockey League history with AHL Authentics. They're auctioning off Hershey Bears and Texas Stars home and away jerseys, as well as game-used pucks from each game. For a complete list of jerseys and your place to bid, log on to theahl.com. AHL Authentic, your only source for great American Hockey League jerseys and collectibles. Back with first period highlights and stats, Bears lead 2-0 from Giants Center, hoping they can put it away tonight. You're watching the 2010 Calder Cup Finals. Back live in Hershey, Pennsylvania, Giant Center, Greg Mace between periods here. And you can see this crowd that has really been unbelievably fired up since they walked into the building, and these fans have gotten the start they wanted to see with their Hershey Bears up 2-0. We welcome all of you watching tonight on ABC 27, as well as Comcast Sportsnet Mid-Atlantic, NHL Network throughout Mid-America, North America, and the Hershey Bears Radio Network. All right, let's take a look at the first period highlights. And boy, did the Bears put pressure on the Texas Stars early. They have outshot them 17-4. And Brent Climie, who has normally been or has been the goaltender quite a bit for this Texas Stars team, went out with a concussion earlier this year. Matt Climie has been their goaltender. He made some great saves here early, but the Bears putting on a lot of pressure. As we said, 17 shots early, and the Bears got off to a very quick start, putting the kind of pressure they wanted. All right, the Bears got on the board first. John Carlson out in front, got the rebound. He'll put it home. You'll see number 4, he's had a lot of big goals this year, and Carlson will stuff it in, and that gave the Bears a 1-0 advantage. Then Carl Alston, watch him on the left side. He'll drive it home. Great puck movement by the Bears to give them a 2-0 advantage. And we talked about the statistical edge for Hershey, and they had it certainly in that first period as they outshot the Texas Stars 17-4 in that first period, and they continue to put the pressure on. Bears capitalizing on the power play, just one penalty so far for Texas, and the Bears, as we said, capitalized on the power play. Second period coming up. We'll rejoin John and Ed up in the broadcast booth when we come back. Bears with a 2-0 advantage after one period of play. You're watching the Calder Cup Finals from Hershey, Pennsylvania.
A dominating performance in the first period by the Hershey Bears. The Texas Stars had more icing violations than they had shots on goal. And the Bears get goals from John Carlson and Carl Alster. They lead it 2-0 as we get ready for the second period here at Giants Center. And for the Texas Stars, boy, do they need a reversal of fortune in a bad way here in front of this sellout crowd of over 11,000 people. We haven't yet heard the official amount, but boy, it's going to be, I'm sure, the biggest crowd this building has ever seen, and perhaps a party like Central Pennsylvania has never known at Coffee tonight as the Bears a 2-0 lead.
Well, if you go by decibels alone, you know that we have to be working with a record crowd here. Every seat filled, everybody in those seats waving their white rally towels as the Bears are on the bench awaiting the faceoff for the start of the second period just after a dominating opening period.
Well, keep this in mind, and we've made mention certainly even before the game tonight, Texas has faced adversity before. In fact, in Game 7, when they could have been eliminated in the Western Conference Finals, they began the game by being outshot 29-5. They gave up the first two goals, and yet they're here because they came back in the third period and they won. So for Hershey, as Yogi Berra would say,
it ain't over till it's over.
Thank you very much. At center, Gagnon up against Keith Acoin, a pair of number 11s to get us going here. The Bears did outshoot Texas 17-4 in the first period, and they win the faceoff with Cron to your left, Michael Noy there now to your right, as the puck cleared into the Bears zone, and Gagnon firing the first shot of the period on net. Michael Noy there watching it hop up over the glass, off the protective netting and out of play. 15 seconds gone by, faceoff in the Bears zone.
Michael Neuberg gets that first touch of the period, which every goalie really can't wait to do. You want to touch it, whether it's just behind the net in the trapezoid, if it's a shot from the side. He just wants to get the feel of that puck and take care of his rebound, and that's what Michael Neuberg did.
Faceoff won by the Bears, and Acoin from behind the net, Jamie Benn. Jumping over quickly to the left wing side, but could do nothing with it. Alsner behind the net, and on a wing to Bork. Pass intercepted by the Stars at center. They come up quickly. Gagnon across the line, a wrister wide, and a rebound for Colton Sevier as he tried to throw it in front. Blocked down by the Bears. Texas a little giddy up going here to begin this second period. Bears with a 2-0 lead here in Game 6 of the Calder Cup Finals. Bears win, they're champions. Texas wins. We're back here on Wednesday night at 7 Eastern. Puck along the wall for Colton Sevier. And a center for Acoin. It's cleared up the wall. Taken over is Jamie Benn, number 14 for Texas. Joined him for the playoffs, and up until Chris Bork took over, he was the leading scorer in the postseason in the American Hockey League. Along the wall, Perreault for Hershey. A hand in the middle, and across into the zone offsides. 18:51 to go in the second period. Faceoff in the neutral zone.
Alexandre Giroux just a step ahead of the play on the left wing as they go across the blue line.
See Matthew Perreault. Had some games with the Washington Capitals this year. He will certainly get a long look come September at Caps camp under Bruce Boudreau in Arlington. The puck back inside Texas territory for Maxime Fortunas. And along the wing to Wathier. He's been very impressive in this series. A physical force on the wall. Clears it along the right side. And for Sawada, along the back wall of the Bears zone. Lost the puck to Jay Beagle. And the Bears are able to clear it away. Texas getting the first two shots of this second period. And along the wing for Helmer. Right wing, couldn't keep it in Texas. Now it's Beagle, open ice. And as he moves in right side, pulling up with him stride for stride, his opposite number and Ethan Graham. Now Fortunas kicks it out of the skates, follows it to center. Fortunas moving to the left board. He'll bring it out on the left side against Helmer. Looks to center, got caught up in the skates of the Hershey captain. And now along the wing, it is brought to the slot. Banning on it was Rallo, and it goes wide of the net. Helmer on the wall, trying to clear and cannot. Rallo behind the net to Wathier. Now a chance as Rallo banks it off the goaltender. All the way out and through Garrett Stafford and into the Texas zone.
Stars being really aggressive with their forecheck, and it's paid off for them, at least in the opening minutes of this period. They've gotten a couple of scoring chances, and they've also been able to penetrate the Bears' defense. What the Bears are doing right is they're making sure once the Stars do get into their zone that they're keeping them on the outside.
Icing call here against the Texas Stars. We've seen a lot out of them tonight in that department. 17:29 to go in the second period. A faceoff back in front of Brent Cron and off to his left. Greg Amadio, there is a heart and soul guy on this roster. You are looking at him right there. as he gets set, Amadio does, with Patrick Weller, Brent Cron watching action from afar. Amadio's shot over the outstretched glove of Cron and wide. McCullough on the wall for Texas, and left wing skating with it across the Hershey line. McCullough flattened by Weller, pinned up along the wall. Rallo following it down in behind the net. And now to Stafford on the wing against Cody Eakin right side. And a puck into the right wing corner. The Bears have possession. Cody Eakin, the rookie, kicks it away from ex-Bear Travis Morin. It will go long enough down ice. Without a star to play it, that will be icing. And a draw back in front of Michael Neubert this time. Just better than 3 minutes gone by in the second period of Game 6 with the Bears up 2-0.
The Stars starting off the period with three unanswered shots. And they've had some success, albeit no scoring in the Bears zone.
A faceoff carried now into the Bears zone, and Beaudoin on the left wing tried to push it low to pair to Lindgren, but on the way, the pickoff by Wilson and a clear to neutral ice. Texas turned it over. Beaudoin tried to move it in. Wilson will bring it in for Hershey instead. Cody Eakin was pushing that way, but Texas, before any threat from the chocolate and white can get started, able to move the puck back out. There's clear right wing corner. Bouchard moves out of there, moves it to the slot. Kane handles, now for Alster, a lane to shoot, and a drive in front. A glove save made by Brent Cron. Good low to the ice save by the Stars' big goaltender. Carl Alster already with a goal tonight and looking for more as he unloads early in the second.
Carl Alster got a lot of time right then as the Stars go into really what has been their MO for the series. They're very, very good at collapsing. When the Bears figure out what they need to do on the ice, they put the puck back to the points. And what will happen until the Stars adjust is you'll have some time and space with your points, the defense that are shooting from the blue line area, to get that puck towards the goal.
In the Texas zone, Pinizzato away from Fortunas and runs into the side of the net. Boy, he got the big wheels turning coming out of the left wing corner that time. Unfortunately for Pinizzato, he runs right into the side of the net and has a pretty good laugh about it at the same time.
Having a conversation with the linesman from the prone position.
Pinizzato got legs going, followed in, and boom, that'll take care of that. Faceoff out of the zone, and that's pretty clear that time.
You've got guys on every line. You've got Pinizzato, you've got Eakin, the young junior called up late in the season for the playoffs. Those legs just do not stop moving.
Along the far board for Ethan Graham. Edged in for the Texas Stars here. Kane left wing for Hershey. Cannot exit against Jamie Benn. Now the puck along into the right wing corner. Andrew Jodrick trying to move out, back checked by Gagnon right in front of the Texas bench. And now it's Pinizzato, open ice, Kane the trailer. Pinizzato in almost the same place again in the left wing corner. This time he's checked off the puck by Maxime Fortunas. They continue to battle it out. The puck long since gone. They still joust at one another. As the puck back to the middle for Keith Acoin, Pinizzato coming to the bench for fresh personnel. 4.5 minutes gone by here in the second period of Game 6 of the 2010 Calder Cup Finals. Wherever you are watching us tonight or listening, we are glad to have you with us from Giant Center in Hershey, PA. As Sevier will bring it into the top of the crease, got it to Neuwehr, and it was easily sticked aside. But Texas with a follow-up try from Wapier along the wall. To Gagnon behind the net. And out of Bork on the wing. 2-on-2. Bears come out. Sawada coming out with almost 5 minutes gone of the period. A trailer in Bork. Right side to Acoin. And Johnny hit the post. Acoin hit the post from the right side up near the crossbar as it comes away. And now on the right wing, Wapier coming through against Telmer. Able to throw him aside, and a puck to the blue line. Center point, Stevenson looks to the front. Shot blocked down right off the leg of Andrew Gordon. Follow-up try from the top of the right circle. Fired in by Peters. Neuwehr now looking for a shot from the left side. The Bears able to clear. And heading down ice, linesman Bob Goodman with the arm in the air. Icing will be the call. 14:33 to go in the second period. The Bears continue to lead it 2-0.
Well, the Stars are having some success in terms of puck possession and the inside the zone. But right now, as we get a look at that shot that hit the crossbar right where it meets the left-hand post.
Pretty much the top right corner right there. So a close call for Brent Cron. And as an old goaltender, you're happy to say
that's part of your equipment. Yeah.
Yep, absolutely. Puck along the near wing, controlled here by the Stars. Stafford barely keeping it in the zone. And cleared right wing corner. Along the right wing side now, Ludwig with a dump in. A coin there with possession, but the Bears cannot exit. Now left circle, a shot in from Rallo, knocked down. Cleared away by Helmer. It never does get to Neuvier. The Bears will move out to center. Skating is a coin. Low on the left wing for Bork. He will whistle a shot wide. And into the right wing side, the carom for Texas. To the middle here for Jamie Benn. 6 minutes gone, second period, game six. Bears 2-0 leaders. Out shooting the Stars 19-8 as Carlson brings it in right side and a puck for Jamie Benn along the wall. Benn will move with it. While the Stars have settled down some of the offense for Hershey as Rallo puts it off the skate of Alsner and far board, they are not generating a ton of chances. Well, they might get a shot now. Power play coming up as the man hauled down into the corner was Travis Morin. John Carlson is going to go to the box. A power play for Texas. When we return, it's 2-0 Hershey. You're watching the 2010 Calder Cup Finals. Coach Troy Mann in the center of your screen. He, his first year with the Bears, and a guy looking for his first Calder Cup win. He runs the penalty kill and the defense on this team. And had the job he's done on the PK unbelievable this year. The Bears for the first time tonight really needing it in this 2-0 game.
You're absolutely right. Special teams, so important. And the Bears penalty kill, I think, speaks for itself as they ice the puck right off the faceoff.
Number one in the American Hockey League in the regular season. See the Stars on a power play at a little better than 20%. There's certainly nothing wrong with that. Bears in penalty kill mode, not as well as they did percentage-wise than they did in the regular season. At 81%, almost 82. That'll work most of the time. Another clear and a shorthanded try as Kane comes in. Gets a shot on Cron. Cron played it pretty well. He is just such a big force for Texas back there. As the puck now for Garrett Stafford. And Texas to the middle with Pair 2 Lindgren. Across the Hershey line. Stafford looks for the shot, fakes it, and brings it into the corner. Bottled there by Travis Morin. Number 23 for Texas. Lost the puck to number 23 for Hershey. Andrew Jodry with a clear. And Texas will back it up.
Well, if we get to a minute gone in the penalty, the Stars have not yet registered their first shot on goal in this power play for them. The Bears really playing it tight, playing man-on-man, and making sure they're not giving a lot of time or space for the Stars to set up.
The puck behind the Hershey net. Stars on a power play for another 43 seconds. As Jancevski, near side to Rallo, brings it all the way to the blue line. The forward does. Now to the side of the net, Gagnon, as he crashes in. And Page gets knocked up but not off. And Jodry on the clear attempt. Only got it about halfway. Jancevski, a cross-ice pass picked up by Rallo. A wrister and a glove save made, and a beauty by Michael Neuvier. Snapping the glove out there and stopping play with 23 seconds left in the power play and approaching the midway point of this second period.
Now this is the confidence that the Michael Neuvier plays with as we have some discussions going on the side. Steve Pinizzato goes back to his bench. Rallo gets it in the on the side, and Neuvier follows the puck perfectly as he comes out to the top of the crease, being very aware that he's got a backdoor man coming in. Knows he has his angle, gets the glove out, and is able to hold it.
Michael Neuvier, you're looking at an NHL goaltender in waiting for the Washington Capitals. He got some time there this year already. And Greg Rallo, even after his shot, Steve Pinizzato letting him know in some way, shape, or form he didn't really care for the shot. And a faceoff again inside Hershey territory. 23 seconds away from a first kill of the night for Hershey. Fortunas along the wall to Jancevski. McCullough watches it hop over the stick, can't control it, bears out of the zone, a coin by Define Bork. Couple of pretty good forwards up front penalty killing here, and Keith Acoin, the league MVP in the regular year, and Chris Bork. Well, you got to believe if the Bears win, could get some support for MVP in the postseason. Far side for Carlson. out of the zone. And now here come the Bears. A coin, right circle, a pass, and broken up. Had Bork along the left side. Couldn't find a way to get it through. Ray Sawada brings it back now for Texas. And the Stars getting outshot 20-10 midway through this game. They trail it 2-0. A collision between Perreault and Scott McCullough at the blue line. It moves on into the Bears zone. And Hershey bringing it back out to center. Matthew Perreault along the right wing side. In with Andrew Gordon. Right wing corner and behind the net. And now for Texas, near wall, Stevenson with a dump out. Too far for Wilson, and Brian Helmer quickly back into his zone. A pass in front, a shot as it came to Pertu Lindgren. Up off of Michael Loy there, and a puck to the right wing side. Great opportunity for Pertu Lindgren right there as it comes to the left wing for Giroux. Ahead and out of the zone. Giroux is in, and a shot blocked as Stevenson took it off the leg. Stars struggling to dump it out on the carom. Second effort sends it out. Ethan Graham able to finish it off. There's into their own end. Carl Alsner, a goal in the first period tonight. Both goals coming from defensemen. If you joined us late, Perreault coming in and stopped by Stevenson. It was John Carlson that had the other. And with just about half of regulation behind us now, here in game six of the Calder Cup Finals, the Bears a 2-0 leader here at Giant Center. Carlson with a puck in his own zone as the Bears skate out to center.
Well, the Bears right now doing their best to get through the neutral zone as quickly as possible. I think that's been a big difference in the game, where the Stars have been held up because the Bears are playing it fairly tight, and the Bears are able to get through and hold the Stars up at both blue lines. When you're hitting them at the blue line, this is what happens. You get these offsides calls.
9:43 to go in the second period. We step aside. Bears halfway through regulation, a 2-0 lead in game six. I've seen so far, for those who may have made the trip from Central Texas, maybe not as much, but the one thing that Texas has been able to do out of here in the second period, it hasn't been nearly as run and gun. If it continued that way, it was going to be bad for the visiting team. They've done that at least so far.
Yeah, they've been able to slow the Bears down a little bit. I think they still have not figured out really how to solve them once the Bears are able to establish possession in the offensive zone. Meanwhile, the Bears are really taking a page out of what the Stars were so successful with at the beginning of these series, and that's taking care of the game between the faceoff dot and the boards.
It's rattle now for Texas as the Stars continue to trail it here 2-0 with a little better than 9 minutes to go in the second period. Pinizzano around Ludwig, a shot and a penalty. Ludwig gave up a step and he was done. Pinizzano using his wheels to draw a penalty, and the play will continue now. It is Alsner along the wing to a coin. He's got it on the left hash, tipped in front. Jodry is there and in the blue paint. It's not quite covered, I guess covered enough. Hooking call on Ludwig. One of those pursuit penalties that will hurt you every time. Pinizzano got a step and it's 2 minutes in the box for Texas and number 24.
And that's what you get. That's your reward. When you keep your feet moving, there's going to be pursuit penalties. The only way you're going to be stopped after you beat a guy is when he gets his stick somewhere on your body from behind, and that's what Ludwig had to do.
I'd say this is a very big power play for Hershey, but a bigger penalty kill for Texas. The Stars keep it 2-0 here. Some momentum to be had, perhaps. But if Texas gives up one here, the hole is going to be a big one. Along the right wing for Bork. In front of a shot chip by Gordon. And over top of the goal. And now on the right wing for Bork. Out to the point. And it is Keith Acoin. Take the shot, brought it back. Bork one-timer, Giroux, and a screamer that goes wide. Back for Acoin as he reloads. Hershey's number one power play unit on here. Looking to get the lead a little bit bigger. At the circle for Acoin, a shot that ricocheted through and just missing as Cron had to have been screened in front, but was in position. Now along the left corner for Acoin. Harassed by Peters. Loose puck to the blue line. Picked up here by Bork. Getting away from the defender in McCullough. And now for Acoin in the left wing circle. One-timer, Giroux wide, and a rebound for Gordon. A wraparound try. Nobody home between the circles. And the Stars are able to clear it.
Just a minute left to go in the penalty. The puck is out of the Stars zone for the first time. And a whistle blows. I'm not quite sure why.
Not sure the fans know either. They point to the blue line here. with 7:56 to go in the second period. Puck was coming back up ice on a Hershey power play. There are still 59 seconds remaining on that man advantage. And referee Frederick Lecuyer here tonight. A faceoff is coming at the Hershey blue line. It will be Eric Gagnon up against Kyle Wilson. Power play here. Continuing for almost another minute.
Bork and Carlson stay out at the points.
Not too surprising as they double shift quite a bit. John Carlson, for all the hockey he has played and all the big time hockey he has played in the last 12 months, boundless energy for number four in the chocolate and white. Back with the puck now, Carlson is. And a Bork along the left wing to center ice and into the zone. Left wing corner, and now to Perreault on the right side. Fortunas in the middle of that. So two is Ethan Graham at the right hash mark. It's Graham on the steal. Back to Fortunas and a pop-up out of the zone that will take it the distance. Michael Loy there with the Bears. Perhaps time for another rush with 23 seconds remaining on this power play. Bring it ahead. And Carlson along the right side. Francois Bouchard, right wing corner, and along the wall. Perreault has it. And coming up near the hash mark, it is picked up. And near the faceoff dot, bombing Bouchard, and now on the wing, Perreault walks in, looking for Cron, and cannot get it through him. Cron cannot cover it, but it will ping pong out to the corner. The penalty ends. Very big penalty kill for the Texas Stars right there. On the counter, they bring it with Rallo. Right circle, a shot fired in, and a save made by Michael Neuwehr. Into the glove, he holds on to it, and a faceoff coming up in the Bears zone with just under 7 minutes to go in this second period.
Michael Neuwehr makes the decision to hold on to the puck as it comes in. Bears needed a change, which they're doing right now. And you always have that transition at the end of a penalty kill or a power play where you have to really get yourself into even strength mode. And that's what the Bears are able to do after Neuwehr holds on to the puck.
Brian Helmer off the faceoff for Hershey with a clear toward Pinizzato. And the Stars with rare offensive pressure in this game. If you could say that about their game seven with Hamilton two in the third period, they turned it all around despite being badly outplayed in the first half or even two-thirds of the contest. Just that cautionary tale thing again. Back along for Jodry as a shot pops up on the second effort. Up over Stevenson and going to the right side. Kane to the right wing corner. And now Jodry following it there. And the Bears emerging with it. Helmer with a shot. He was looking perhaps a tip from Pinizzato, but he couldn't get to it in time. And between the circles, Pinizzato fighting with Jamie Benn for it. Jodry was there too, but the puck sent by Jancevski to the blue line. Bears are changing, and the Stars will start in their own zone.
The Bears once again applying some pressure in the offensive zone, and the Stars just trying to get the puck out, and that's their main goal right now is the Bears are able to set up and move the puck around.
It is Jay Beagle on the left wing for Carlson and across to Perreault, finding Giroux, left circle, a shot, and going just wide. Back along the wall, picked up and sent out of the zone. Close call for Texas. Giroux behind the play, jousting with Landon Wilson a little bit as Beaudoin coming in now on the right wing, and Lindgren a centering attempt for Texas and intercepting. Now the Bears getting back to a little more run and gun here. Giroux, right circle, a shot, and he scores! Patrick McNeil! 3-0 Hershey! Late in the second period!
Giroux is going to get the puck from Jodry. He comes in along the right wing, stops at the faceoff circle, takes that wrister. Cron is not able to take care of the rebound once again. Patrick McNeil was coming in from the blue line to follow the puck going into that post, and he picked it up as he came in and just whacked it home before Cron could relax or could respond.
With just better than 5 minutes left here in this second period, Patrick McNeil, maybe the biggest goal of his life. It gives Hershey a 3-0 lead in game six. And Texas reeling now with Stevenson back in his zone. And a puck brought across. McNeil able to knock it down. And at the blue line, it is carried in and shot in on Cron, covered loose in front, and Helmer will reload. Amadio with a drive, and it's knocked down. This one clear to the middle. And back it comes into the Bear zone. Jay Beagle, an assist as well as Alexander Giroux. Late here in the second with Texas. Across now with Fortunas. A puck knocked down, and the Bears making their way out with Andrew Gordon. The shots are 25-12 in favor of Hershey. And the Bears, a big if not commanding 3-0 lead now with 4:15 to go in the second. A whistle and a timeout. Chocolate Town, USA is going crazy. Bears up 3-0 late in the second.
Well, something that I think you have.
You get a look at the bench here at Giant Center in Hershey. Trainer Dan Stuck on your right, assistant coach Troy Mann and the Bears. Mark French on the edge of your screen. What a feeling Mark French must have right about now.
Well, it's a feeling, but I think it's also a sense of mission where he knows that you cannot let up on this Texas Stars team. It's a team that knows how to shut you down in their defensive zone, but they also know how to score the clutch goals in the offensive zone.
Michael Neuwert throwing that one aside here late in the second period for the Texas Stars after winning two games here in this building. That must seem like a long time ago now, as the number one team in the regular season in the AHL and the best ever as far as wins. The first team in American Hockey League history to win 60 games. That's what the Bears did in the regular year, defeating Bridgeport, defeating Albany, and most recently in the Eastern Conference Finals, the Manchester Monarchs. The Monarchs gave Hershey fits. So too has this Texas team. By the Bears right now in game six, up 3-0. Bears defeated Manchester in six. They are hoping for the same here tonight. It is cleared on the right wing side. Down ice and deep. Touched up, Weller will get there for an icing call with 3:18 to go in the second.
Well, something that I think you have to really keep in mind, John, is that once you score three goals, you're taking the Stars out of their comfort zone. This is a team whose average is 2.95 goals a game, while they're letting in 2.74 goals a game in the playoffs. So they keep it pretty tight. Once you get a lead like this, they really have to step out of the type of game that they're used to playing.
Puck along the right wing now, and Bork looking to put it in the middle. Gordon was there. The Stars with pressure with McCullough out on the points. McNeil trying to keep it in. 3 minutes to play. Second period here at Giant Center in game six. The Texas Stars looking for a reversal of fortune that has eluded them so far tonight. Really from the first goal scored by John Carlson. Jancevski in the blue line for Texas. And a puck down the wall picked up by the Bears. Chris Bork. Still the leading scorer in Calder Cup play. Pressured Cron going after a loose puck. But Texas able to settle things down quickly. Greg Rallo out to center to McCullough. Rallo with a pass left side. The Stars in now with Travis Morin and a shot going over top of the goal. Along the near wing, Amadio with a clear along the wing to Giroux. Ahead of the Texas line. Alex no further. Is that going to be delay a game? Looks like it is. As the puck out of the zone, Stevenson is going to argue this, but a delay a game penalty coming up on Texas with 2:18 to go in the second. Number 20 in the green, gold, and black has a seat. And a power play coming. A goal here, Adam. The Stars are in real trouble.
Oh, absolutely. And a referee has no choice but to make that call. There's really no wiggle room for a delay of game. The puck goes out, it goes out. There's nothing else you can do about it. As Brett Cron gets set for the faceoff just to his right on the faceoff circle.
It looked like the attempted clear from Stevenson by the glass, only a couple of inches over top, but that is all it takes. And a faceoff to the right of Cron. Carlson directing some traffic as the Bears look to set up. A blast in here going wide. Cron can't cover. Wilson looking for the pass in front. And it's sent away by Fortunas along the right wing side. Carlson has to scramble to the point but does. Now to Wilson behind the net for Hershey. Number 18, a perennial 30-goal scorer for the Bears since coming here in the 06-07 season. Carlson, right wing side to Bouchard. And now to Perreault at the bottom of the circle, harassed by Fortunas. Bouchard in to help. Trapezoid bound, and now he'll skate left wing side. Minute 20 remaining on the power play as Bork finding Bouchard, and now high slot for Carlson. Good puck movement by the Bears, still looking for a shot, though, to take. No one home in the left point as the pass came that way. That's going to give Lapierre the chance to clear it.
Well, the Bears once again moving the puck really well inside the zone, and the puck actually being cleared because of a miscue by the Bears.
Now on the right wing side, Alexander Giroux able to clear it in on the wall. The final 70 seconds of period one as Stafford got hit hard by Andrew Gordon. And now Bork at the left point for Perreault in the circle. Now a shot coming in from Giroux, blocked down by the Stars as it goes to the wall. 1 minute to go, second period here in game six. Perreault for Bork, and near the left circle, Bork held up, puck coming through, and Cron going down. Gordon from behind the net, out to Bork, across for the one-timer, and a save made, and a good one by Brent Cron as Giroux lights up a candle from the top of the right circle, but Cron is equal to the task.
Well, Giroux set up his housekeeping right where he likes to get the puck. As Bork gets tripped up, but stays with it, and behind the net, Gordon has it, passes it out to Bork again. Giroux sets up near their face-off dot. Let's go with the one-timer. Cron does the best thing he possibly can, gets down nice and low, makes the stop, and holds on to the rebound.
Brent Cron has seen the bulk of vulcanized rubber come his direction tonight. 27 of the 39 shots in this game have been directed at him. Near side, Giroux makes a step in front, denied by Fortunas as he got close to Cron's goal crease. Now on the right side, Chris Bork into the circle, a pass in front off the tape of a coin and into the left wing corner, moving it along the wing. Bork up top, moving for McNeil, a shot off the blocker of Cron. Down to 15 seconds left in the period. No doubt another big ovation coming from the Giant Center crowd in moments. As the Bears move to the blue line, and a shot from Bork whistling in. Cron seeing it come all the way. And one more draw here in the second period with 7.4 to go.
Well, Cron deciding that discretion is the better part of valor. And even though no Bears were coming in with the rebound, Cron made a really clean catch of that. He just decided why drop it and take the chance as his team tries to clear it. He just held on, and he'll go for the percentages with a faceoff just to his right.
Chris Bork right there on the Hershey bench, a leading scorer in this postseason in the American Hockey League in the Calder Cup playoffs. Well, behind the net, Jancevski able to clear it away. McCullough with a dump in, and two periods of game six are in the books here at Giants Center, and 11,000 rally towels start to wave in unison. The Bears are 20 minutes away from the Calder Cup, leading it 3-0 here at the GC.
Well, the shots now 29-12 after the end of the second period, and with the score 3-0, you kind of wonder what is going to be said inside the locker room of not only the Stars, but the Bears too. The Bears know that they have to keep playing the game. They know the history of this team and how they can come back.
Let's go downstairs. Greg May standing by with the head coach of the Bears, Mark French.
Mark, I thought obviously not only a significant goal, but the fact they were putting a little bit more pressure on you in that second period.
Yeah, you knew that they would make a push after the first period. I thought we did a good job defensively in coming back and really taking away any real clear scoring opportunities. I thought the penalty kill was big. And obviously to score the third goal, it was a big goal.
Big heads-up play by Patrick there.
Yeah, he's an offensive defense who's got good vision. He needs to jump up into the play like that to be an effective player, and he picked a good time.
Not a whole lot probably to say here to them in this third period, I would think, as you head into the locker room.
No, we've trusted our leadership all year, and Brian Helmer's done a great job of keeping the dressing room grounded, and we'll count on him again to do that.
Mark, thanks.
Thanks, Greg.
All right, Mark French heads to the locker room to talk to his team. Up 3-0, and this crowd is ready to celebrate here at Giants Center. This second period has been sponsored by Pepsi, by Capital Blue Cross, and by Reese's. Back with Puckhead, Lamont Buford, when we come back. You're watching the 2010 Calder Cup Finals. All right, let's get it. Back live, Giants Center, Hershey, Pennsylvania, Game 6 of the Calder Cup Finals. The Hershey Bears on the verge of their 11th Calder Cup with a 3-0 lead. Tonight's game presented by Capital Blue Cross. Well, we're in Section 117 with a lot of very excited Bears fans, including the man who has been the head cheerleader for this entire Giants Center for many years. Puckhead Lamont Buford is with us. Now, for people who don't know the story, you were here for a long time. Now you're out in St. Louis. But explain, because you didn't really intend, this was not the intent when you took a job here at Giants Center to be this figurehead.
No, it wasn't my intention at all. Matter of fact, we were doing a commercial shoot, and it actually ended up running here on the Jumbotron as a practical joke. They ran it a couple times. A few people started doing it. They held it up for a playoff game, and it just took off from there.
Now, over the years, as you walk the hallways here, and I know even when you've gone out, people say, look, it's Puckhead.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. I mean, you never thought that something like this, something so small, would turn out to be this big, but it's tradition here in Hershey. Yeah, I mean, after every goal you see, everybody does it, so it's a great thing.
Now, you're with the St. Louis Blues now, but we brought you back here. The Bears have brought you back two straight years. What has it been for you to go out on the ice, particularly tonight, and get this kind of reception?
It's been unbelievable. When you step out here, you know, and you see all these fans, how passionate they are. They're going crazy. They're waving their towels, and they're cheering on their team. It's unbelievable.
All right, for people who tuned in late, haven't seen this before, go ahead. Folks, here's Puckhead Lamont. You guys ready? Here we go.
Here we go. You ready? B-E-A-R-S, Bears, Bears, Bears. B-E-A-R-S, Bears, Bears, Bears. B-E-A-R-S, Bears, Bears, Bears.
It's working so far, Lamont. Thanks.
Hey, thank you, Greg.
All right, Lamont Buford, Puckhead. The crowd is ready, hoping they're going to bring home a Calder Cup. It would be the first time since 1980. A lot of these folks weren't even born in 1980, the last time the Bears won a Calder Cup over the old Hershey Park Arena. When we come back, highlights, statistics, and perhaps the raising of the Calder Cup. You are watching the 2010 Calder Cup Finals from Hershey. Center Greg Mace together with John Walton and Ed Coffey. We're a sellout crowd seeing the Hershey Bears with a 3-0 advantage and the Bears with a chance to clinch their first Calder Cup at home since 1980. And as we said before, the last time they did it was at the old Hershey Park Arena, which was the oldest working hockey arena in North America, where they beat the New Brunswick Hawks back in 1980. And rather ironically, on that New Brunswick Hawks team, their top player was the now coach of the Washington Capitals, former coach of the Hershey Bears, who also won a Calder Cup with the Bears, Bruce Boudreau, great American Hockey League player, and he played against the Bears when they last won a Calder Cup at home. Well, if you're interested in great AHL merchandise, as well as the latest American Hockey League news, you can log on to theahl.com. Check out the American Hockey League store and AHL Authentic, where you can purchase game-used Calder Cup merchandise like pucks and jerseys. Log on now, theahl.com. It's your best and only source for American Hockey League merchandise and news. Well, this crowd, as we said, has been into every single play, fired up every single moment, and now, for the first time, as we said, in 30 years, this crowd on the verge of seeing a Calder Cup championship at home. The Bears had a chance to win the Calder Cup at home last year against the Manitoba Moose, but lost the game and then had to win the game out in Manitoba. So this crowd knows what it's like, but this time around the Bears are in a lot more control. All right, let's take a look at the second period of highlights. And again, we thought the Texas Stars came out with a whole lot more pressure and clearly had to put a lot of pressure on Michael Neuberg and the Hershey Bears. In fact, they outshot the Bears for most of that third period until we got to the second half of that period, and Neuberg continuing to come up with save after save here. And a little bit more hard hitting. We'll have to see how hard Texas comes out and hits. The Bears obviously want to be disciplined here in this third and final period, because a goal or two certainly get the Texas Stars back into the game. Had a couple of penalties, but a great heads-up play by Patrick McNeil. He's a defenseman. Giroux. And there's McNeil on the rebound. Patrick McNeil with a great follow. Great heads-up play. Giroux got that to work. And there's McNeil right out in front to put home goal number 3 for the Hershey Bears. Well, we take a look at the statistics. And remember, after the first period of play, the Bears, who came out on fire and had a 2-0 lead, had outshot Texas 17-4. Well, now the shots a little bit more even, but the Bears certainly dominated the second half of that second period. Bears are the only team that's capitalized on the power play, and the Stars have taken 6 penalty minutes, 3 total penalties. The Bears just one. But the big story on the scoreboard, 3-0 Hershey. We go to the third period. Bears fans are hoping this is the final one of the year at Giant Center. John Walton, Ed Coffey back with a call after this. You're watching the 2010 Calder Cup Finals.
The Springfield Indians 19 years ago went back-to-back in winning the Calder Cup. No team has done it since, but now 20 minutes away, the Hershey Bears could do the same thing again. Winning last year against Manitoba in 6 games, they have a 3-2 lead. And here in game 6 in the third period, we'll take a 3-0 lead in. This is as loud, Ed Coffey, as I have ever heard this building since it opened in 2002 right now.
Without a doubt, when you can feel the vibrations up in our broadcast booth, you know you've got some serious decibels going on as Lamont Parkhead gets everything going here by waving that rally towel, a longtime fixture at the Giant Center.
In this great game of hockey for 2009 and 2010, we might be watching the last period. The Stanley Cup in the National Hockey League, the Kelly Cup in the ECHL, long since put to bed. And the Bears trying to finish us off and send us into summertime. The third period underway, and Carlson with a puck along the wall to center. Jamie Benn for Texas. Benn has been very quiet in this series. If Texas ends up falling to Hershey tonight, the production of Jamie Benn, and more specifically the job Carl Alsner has done on him in this series, will be one of the reasons why. Along the wall for Sevier as it moves out of his skates, and Sevier battling his way in. The Bears attacking with purpose to center. It is Bork sitting in. A line change quickly here with a puck behind the Stars' net.
Well, the Bears right now, I think, are playing this very smartly, where they might be tempted to go into that shell. You can't do that against the Texas Stars. They're still sending a man deep to go in and get that forecheck going, and they're still trying to stop the Stars in that neutral zone so they can't get anything started.
That graphic you saw should have said 3-1 in the playoffs when leading after two periods. And if that sounds low to someone who's just watching this series, that will tell you how many times the Bears have come from behind or it's been tied after two periods. And when you know they played in 9 overtime games, winning 8, you know why they're here.
And that's a scenario that was not around during the regular season. Very, very rarely were they not leading after two periods.
Lothier with a clear in now for Texas. For the Stars, if it is to be, it better be pretty soon. Along the far board, Sawada. And taken here by Beagle. The Bears to center. Beagle in along the right wing. A shot here on Cron, and no rebound allowed here. Cron's given up a few of those tonight, but at this critical juncture, he does not. A minute 18 into the third period.
Well, the Bears get their first shot of the period. Cron holds it. It's the shots now 30-12 in favor of the Bears. The score 3-0 with 18:42 left to go in the final period, and hopefully for the Bears, the final period of the season.
Matthew Perreault very close to getting a stick on that. If he did, things might have been a little different right now. Along the near side, Travis Morin, the clear back into the Bears zone. Carlson and McCullough raise sticks. McCullough gets knocked down. Rallo pursuing. He is dogged by Wilson. Rallo up top to the blue line. And now for Stafford as he moves behind the net. McCullough on the stuff around denied. Rallo looking for a man and Morin. This line's been very good for Texas, especially for the games in Cedar Park Center, generating perhaps their best opportunities. That does get back, however, to the Jamie Benn conversation and his lack of productivity in this series. Clear to the blue line. Picked up here by Bouchard. And now the puck into the left circle. McCullough now in behind the net with Travis Morin helping out. A little bit better than 2 minutes gone here in the third period of game 6. As the puck is moved to center. Ludwig back now for Texas. Number 24 with a pass to Rallo at center. blasted in well wide and falling safely behind the Hershey goal cage for Craig Amadio.
Well, the Bears right now having to deal with the star, the last line. You mentioned it, that they had given the Bears a little bit of trouble, and were cycling very well down in their own zone.
Shots 30-12 in favor of Hershey as the puck cleared into the Texas zone. And along the right side for Weller, banging around with Landon Wilson. Pinizzato from a sharp angle, putting it wide. And now for Amadio, the Bears utterly dominating the shot department and the quality scoring tries in this game. As Amadio in the middle here against Baudouin, clears it in. Bears are changing. Short shifts, and certainly the excitement that's building on the Bears bench. They know there's a lot of time left, but into the third period, they've got a 3-0 lead. And Texas, not too many good opportunities tonight against Michael Loy there. 11,000 strong, screaming, "Let's go Bears!" As Gagnon comes in left side for the Stars to Sevier behind the net. Sevier gets away from a coin and a chance in close on the far side. Jamie Benn denied by Neubert. Bears come out. Near side, Bork, a shot, too much wind, up and out of play. 16:28 to go in the third period, and a faceoff coming up in the Star zone.
Well, the Bears break out of their defensive zone, and I think that's been a story, one of the scenarios the entire night. You're kind of building a storyline here where they're coming out with that transition from defense to offense. They pick it up. You've got a man in center making that curl towards the puck, and always two men coming out of the zone and getting through the neutral zone as quickly as possible. So even when you don't get the shot on goal, what you are doing is getting the shot deep. That time, hitting a star stick and then going out of play.
A coin to take a faceoff here, and he fires it to the side of the net. The Bears continue to cycle and continue to attack with a puck behind the goal for a coin. Andrew Gordon, along the near wing, lost the puck, trying to cut to the net. Lafayette with it now for the Stars. Number 38 with a puck cleared into the zone. Bears from behind the net. Near side, out now for Bork. Jancevski, a chop at it to keep it in. That doesn't work. Lafayette only realizing now he's got a touch up. And the Bears with plenty of time to send a coin to the right side. And now to Patty McNeil. A goal tonight for McNeil as it comes out to center. All three goals, if you join us, play scored by defensemen. If the Bears do win this thing tonight, the D-men are the guys you're going to want to see in the locker room. Along the right-hand side, they have been terrific tonight as the puck for Weller deep in his own zone. Speaking of D-men, Jay Beagle with a clear to center. 15 and a half to play in a third. Perreault across to Giroux, takes it from the left circle, firing it in. Brent Cron really backed up into his goal that time. But no problem, at least this moment. Back along the right side, and Beagle, right circle looks. Not much against Ludwig. Now back to the blue line. First game in 36 days for Brent Cron. He's on the short end of a 3-0 count here in game 6 of the Calder Cup Finals. Beagle, blue line, Carlson. Across now to Walsner. And now to Giroux as he tried to get a shot away against Ludwig. Second attempt is blocked. And Giroux loads up a third time, got this one through, but Cron makes the save. Rebound to Jamie Benn. Benn across the Texas line and stopped by Beagle. Good, strong puck play by Beagle as he rides Jamie Benn off the puck, a big, strong guy in his own right. Back along the right wing for Kane. And as he's pinned on the wall, penalty coming, it's on Hershey. The Stars are going to get a power play here. As Sevier from behind the net, a touch up for the Bears. A penalty here and a hold, I believe, on Kane back in the Texas zone.
Well, back in the defensive zone, he was trying to chase down Fortunas, and he got a stick stuck up under his arm, and was trying to pull it out. That turns into a hook. And, the Bears will be down a man now for 2 minutes.
A face-off coming up to the left of Michael Neuber. For the Stars, a power play they almost have to convert. For if they do not, you're looking at 12 and a half minutes and three goals still needed. But cleared away immediately by the Bears down ice, and a penalty kill off to a good start.
Bears playing that conservatively. Patty McNeil gets it on the side board and decides that he doesn't want an outlet pass. He just wants to get the puck out of the zone, and he takes care of business in the classic sense.
Now along the right wing, Fortunas across to Jancevski. Wathier parks himself at the top of the goal crease. A shot fired in here and bounding wide as Gagnon goes to the wall. And Rallo there for Texas at the right hash mark. To Wathier behind the net. He'll follow it to the left wing corner. Along the wall right side, Fortunas had to scramble to get there. He'll send it across to Jancevski. Now in the right circle, too far for Rallo. Helmer back to try and clear. McNeil with some help ahead to Jodry, and the Bears will run off some time.
Bears are showing a little different look in their penalty kill right now, really being a lot more aggressive than they usually are. They usually set up in that small box and play position and keep the other team on the outside. They're going right after the man with the puck right now, and it seems to be paying off in some dividends for them.
The puck along the right wing, and Jamie Benn will carry it in for Texas. His shot over top of Neubert and over top of the net, staying in play right side. And now the Stars with Travis Morin. Morin up top. He finds Pertu Lindgren. Lindgren along the left circle. Sticking away his Allsters, but not out of the zone. Jamie Benn near the right point. And now at the blue line across to Lindgren. It is down to Morin as he tries to center, and it's covered by Michael Neubert with 12:53 to go in the third period. It may have been a disappointing end for the Washington Capitals and in the Stanley Cup playoffs, but the future as bright as anywhere than in the Washington organization with what the Bears have done in four of the last 5 years.
Oh, absolutely, with what they have and the depth in this organization. And that goes right through to the coaching from the Washington Capitals down to the East Coast League Stingrays. They use the same system. You can fill in with players when you have injuries. And look at the players on the ice right now and who you expect will be up with Washington next season.
Caps Vice President and General Manager George McPhee combining with President GM Doug Yingst here at Hershey as a shot from Stafford comes in and a Jamie Benn far side. Stafford trying to get a puck through and Allsner on the wing far board. Jodry with a clear and a backhander that goes down ice.
Well, the Bears just playing that aggressive penalty kill, going right after it as the clock ticks down. 3-2-1, and the penalty's over.
Boyd Kane is out. McCullough in the zone, and a shot off Neubert that goes up and out of play. This crowd getting revved up as we step aside. The Bears, a little bit better than 12 minutes from the Calder Cup. It's 3-0 Chocolate Town. A 3-0 lead for Hershey in Game 6. And this crowd is feeling it. With a face-off to the left of Michael Neubert. And a drop a second time as a coin will come out. In his stead will be Chris Bourque. The shots up to the minute. 32-13 in favor of the Hershey Bears. And a puck that comes out of the zone, Jancevski. Back into the Stars' end and ahead to center for Peters. And now to McCullough as he lost it at the Bears' blue line. Gordon will clear it back in. For Texas, the chances have been so few and so far between tonight, they have just not gotten the offense going. At their best in this series, they were getting enough offense and just trapping terrific defense and good goaltending, quite honestly, for Matt Kleine, especially in the first two games. But even in a losing effort, in games 3, 4, and 5, Kleine pretty good. Icing the call here against Texas. Bring it back in front of Michael Neubert. But tonight, the defense didn't get the job done in the first period, and the offense just hasn't been found.
Well, that's absolutely true. And Brent Kron not doing a bad job in goal. He's had a lot of work to do. He's seen a lot of rubber already with 32 shots with still 11:45 left to go in this period. But the Bears are cycling really well down low. They're making sure that they get the puck out to the points, and that's been the key. You get the shot from the point, and then you have a player down low that's able to go for the rebound.
Michael Neubert will watch a draw to his left, and as the Bears win it, Amadio rims it around the wall. Kept in by Jamie Benn. There to Lindgren with a centering try. Jamie Benn with a shot. Landon Wilson with a try in the backhand and a save made. Michael Neubert able to turn that away. And a puck clear down now to center. Ethan Graham back for the Stars. Pressured with one man high in a coin. He will trail off to the bench and Beagle will take his place. The Stars from behind their goal. Watching time slip away in a terrific inaugural campaign for the Stars as Carlson firing a shot wide, winning three rounds of the postseason and even the first two games of this series before dropping three in a row at home. And right now, with 11 minutes to play, they're on the short end of a 3-0 count. Carlson ahead now to center. Ahead for Giroux as he finds it right wing to Perreault. Perreault stopped along the wall, and Beagle is in to help. Along the wall, Alsner with a shot here in front, and a glove save made. Claude, the best save he's made tonight. Sprawling out with a glove and holding on with 10:45 to play.
Cron comes out to the edge of his crease and was really right on top of that. Didn't want to take the chance as Perreault puts the puck all the way across the ice and the shot comes in. And that was really through some traffic also with Bears and Stars in front of Brent Cron. And he had to stretch out his complete 6'5" frame in order to hold on to that puck, and there's no rebound.
And he did a nice job of doing it. A faceoff won by Wilson, and Patrick McNeil from behind the net along the right wing. Colton Sevier for Texas. Near wall, Helmer will center it up, but it is controlled by the Stars and Matt Beaudoin. Beaudoin, a guy who played sparingly for the Bears, up and down between here and the ECHL. He has been among the most physical forces in this series in the, between these two teams. Bouchard. Now tailing off as Ludwig will bring it ahead to center. 10 minutes and 10 seconds. All that remains in hockey season across North America. If the Bears can hang on to this lead. As it comes off McCullough and now back inside Bears territory for the Stars. It is now or it is most certainly never. The Western Conference champions are in a real tight spot now. As the puck for Moran in the middle. Number 23 for Texas, across the line, over the glove of Michael Neuwirth. Far side, McNeil. And now to the right wing corner, Andrew Jodry, stick handling in traffic. The product of the University of Wisconsin. Jodry in with a backhander and a save made. Jodry, one of the eight overtime game-winning goals for Hershey this postseason. The old record was six in Calder Cup play. The Bears breaking it against Manchester in game six of the Eastern Conference Finals and extending it with Giroux's game winner in this series in game five in Cedar Park. Along the left wing, it is dumped in by Kane. And that clock running very quickly now, seemingly, on the Stars. And there's 9 minutes remaining at this point.
And the Bears still maintaining that they need to force the play. And they're keeping two men fairly deep in that offensive zone on the forecheck and really getting in front of the Stars in the neutral zone also and not letting them develop anything.
Chris Bork from behind the net, a bad bounce in front, and a shot off Sawana's stick and a save. And it came off Neuwirth and then went to the wall. Bears able to clear. Even when something surprises him, Michael Neuwirth dialed in.
Possibly the scariest moment of the game is the puck took a real sketchy bounce off the back wall and back of Michael Neuwirth and came right out in front.
Keith Acoy looks to center, stopped here by Wathier. He gets through Acoy, but then the puck was poke checked away. Stars able to recover in their own zone. 8:13 to play here in the third period of game six. With a puck along the wall. Stars with Fortunas to center. It is cleared in by Texas. Press troops over the wall for Glenn Gulletson's team, and what a job he's done with this Texas club this year. Everything the Bears have wanted in this series, to be sure. A lot of close games that could have gone either way. Jamie Benn right side, and a shot off a skate play to McNeil. And along the near wing for Jay Beagle. Sevier down the intercept. Right side, a shot, and going wide. Gagnon just missing as it comes away. Bears able to clear Stevenson, starting from his own end.
One of the few times in this period that a man from the Stars has been left unchecked by the Bears in the defensive zone, and the shot goes wide.
It is Giroux behind the net, shaking off a defender. He'll move to the right side. Jay Beagle, right wing corner, cycling behind him. Now the puck to the blue line, Alsner, across to Carlson. And as he gets to the high slot, shadowed by Jamie Benn, a puck behind the net to Jay Beagle. Only 15 shots for Texas in this game. The Bears have 34. Chance of we want the cup now here at Giant Center. With a puck for Stevenson along the right side. The Stars to center. How intimidating must this be for the visiting team right now? Giroux getting around the defender, but a penalty coming up. Stevenson will go. and the Bears, a third period power play when we come back for Central PA, for hockey everywhere. Are you ready for it? We're back after this, 3-0 Hershey. We'll ever be in, and tonight, hockey might even trump chocolate as the puck is cleared away. Back into the Bears zone, and it's a power play for the Bears to try and seal it.
And how fitting that people throughout North America, United States and Canada, are able to listen and watch the game tonight.
The Stars on a penalty kill they have to have. The Bears with a puck at center. Chris Bourque will move it back into his zone. 3-0 Hershey with 6:20 to play in the third period of Game 6 of the Calder Cup Finals. The Bears trying to go back-to-back and be the first AHL team to do so in nearly 20 years. From behind the net, Halsner takes a spill. That might be the ugly. Back along the wall, back up for Carlson, and picked up along the center. Now the only thing Halsner hasn't done right tonight. Back in behind the net, Fortunas, as Bourque is there. Good pressure for the Bears into their zone. A minute to go of power play time. 5:50 remaining in regulation, and this place ready to erupt as the puck ahead for Bourque and into the slot for a coin. A pass across, the Stars just barely clear it away. Fired to the right wing corner and done so by Aaron Gagnon. The puck recovered by Ethan Graham. Graham ahead of the wall, right wing side and in. 5:25 remains here in the third period of Game 6. Chocolate Town on the verge of celebration here as Wilson will bring it across center ice. It is Perreault right side and for Helmer at the point. Bring it across to McNeil. A wrist and he scores! McNeil second! And the Calder Cup is just 5 minutes a change away!
The Bears really taking it easy on this power play, where they weren't real overdoing it in terms of aggression in the zone, because they wanted to make sure above all that there was no odd man rushes or shorthanded goals. Very simple play. Helmer puts it across to Patty McNeil. Patty McNeil takes the shot, it gets through, and it eludes Brent Cron.
It is absolute bedlam here at Giants Center. The Bears are 5 minutes away from repeating as Calder Cup champions. Boyd Kane along the left wing with a puck cleared along the right side. Andrew Jodry, chance of We Want the Cup, absolutely deafening now. With a puck along the wall. And now for Boyd Kane behind the net, Texas tying it up. With a 35-15 shot advantage, the Bears have done this with authority. Patrick McNeil, two goals in this, what looks to be decided, Game 6 here at Giants Center. All four goals by defensemen. The puck along the far side for Sevier in front. A stick save made by Michael Loy there. Fortunas with a drive. Leg pass save. And the Bears trying to clear. Stafford with a puck now. Along the wall for Jamie Benn. Fortunas with a puck near wing. Off the stick to Pinizzotto. And out of the zone.
Pinizzotto does not stop playing. He only has one gear, and that's high as he dives across the ice to get that puck out of the zone. Every shift, every play, no matter what the score, just as important to Steve Pinizzotto, and that's what makes him so valuable to this team.
3:40 left. The Bears, 4-0 leaders, and a Calder Cup in sight as Michael Neubert makes a glove save. We step aside one final time. The Calder Cup is just around the corner here at Hershey tonight. That is what they are looking for. The Hershey Bears, a 4-0 leader, in what has been a fairly dominating performance, Stars with a quick shot on net here. But this crowd, it almost doesn't matter at this point what's going on the ice to these fans who have waited to see for 30 years a championship won in Hershey, and Ed Coffey, they're about to.
Well, very rarely do you get to use the word frenzy when you're talking about a sport. And right now, the Giant Center in Hershey, Pennsylvania is in the midst of a frenzy.
It is indeed, as the puck along the wing for pair two Lindgren. 3.5 to go, and the Bears comfortably in front. A storybook season for the Texas Stars will not end the way they want it to, but for a team that has caught the eye and the passion of not only Cedar Park, but Austin, Texas, a tremendous city, a shot as Lindgren comes in here. They have supported their team in Texas so very well. And Austin and Cedar Park and Central Texas, such a wonderful area. And it is so great to see hockey thriving there, and we certainly hope it does for years and years to come.
And we also have to give kudos to the fans out there who were extremely hospitable to the Hershey fans.
Yes,
that went out. Very friendly, showed them around, shook hands. It was a great time for everybody that attended.
Some of the greatest fans we've run across in our postseason travels in Cedar Park, Texas. As the puck for Texas now out of their zone with under 3 minutes left, the Bears look to clear. And now the puck that comes up into the seats with 2:49 left. In May of 1980, Bruce Boudreau playing for the New Brunswick Hawks, losing to Claude Noel and the Hershey Bears at Hershey Park Arena. And since then, both of those gentlemen have gone on to bigger and better things in the coaching world. And for the Bears, they have not celebrated a cup in Hershey since.
And the fans are ready for it. They're primed.
They are very, very much ready here in Hershey tonight. Michael Noy there to watch the draw to his left. Just a little bit more hockey, and it will be summertime across North America. As Sawada will send it to Wathier behind the net. And now to Weller as the hit is put on there. The Bears, like they have all season, have defended home ice with vigor, have scored a lot of goals early, and it was the recipe they were looking for tonight. And for Mark French, with a bar raised so high in this organization, Ray Sawada along the wall to Wathier as it comes out to center. All you're following, if you're Mark French, is play stops here. Not much, just a guy who went on to the NHL Coach of the Year and won a cup. A guy in the NHL and Bob Woods who won a cup. And he might have topped it all with 60 wins and going back to back. What Mark French and Troy Mann have done with this team is absolutely remarkable.
Well, just a what will be and what has been a legendary season. And you I think you hit the nail on the head when you say the bar has been raised so high to what really climax with this point with 2:06 left to go in the game. The Bears ahead 4-0, shots 35-22.
We reference the Binghamton Rangers 93, the best win total in AHL history prior to what the Bears did, 57 of them. They lost in the second round that year to the Rochester Americans. The Bears topped it by 3 wins this year, and 2 minutes from now, they will cap off the greatest season in American Hockey League history. The puck along the wall far side as it's picked up by Ludwig. And now for Travis Morin, for Jodry behind the net. You are watching the end of a season that may never be topped in a long and proud history of not only the Hershey Bears, but the American Hockey League. As the Texas Stars move to center, it is cleared in far side, and the Bears begin from behind the net. 90 seconds from a championship. As the crowd standing here at Giant Center, this is what they were looking for tonight. Stevenson behind the net, away to the middle. Not a single person of 11,002 tonight's attendance are sitting. The puck loose in front of Brent Cron, and McCoy will send it near wing. 1 minute to go. Patrick McNeil back into his zone. The puck along the wall. And McNeil along the near side, clearing it ahead toward Bork. A 4-0 lead for Hershey with 40 seconds left. Calder waiting in the wings. A coin by Hedlund, one man back. And a puck in front, Bork breakaway, save made by Cron as he looked for icing on the cake. And now the final seconds as the Bears jumping up and down on the bench. And the decibel level so loud, it sounds as if the roof might come off. Ryan Helmer back into his own zone. And that is going to do it. As Ryan Helmer away, good morning, good afternoon, and good night, Texas. The Hershey Bears have gone back-to-back Calder Cup champions.
Were how are we going to not disappoint the fans, and how are we going to keep up with the bar that was raised last year with the great season that the Bears had and the Calder Cup finish that they had? And we thought it's almost impossible, even though we have a good team. We knew we were going to get far during the season, but I could not have dreamt in my wildest dreams that we would get to this point right now at the beginning of the season. We have topped everything in the history, basically, of the American Hockey League. As the players are on the ice now, you can see the love in these players' eyes for each other, for the coaching staff, how they've been able to come together. The smiles are real smiles. The camaraderie is real camaraderie, and they don't want to end this moment at all. This is the most emotional moment that I have witnessed at Giant Center.
And now the handshake at center ice as the Texas Stars, the Western Conference champions, awaits the newly minted champions of the American Hockey League, the 2009-2010 Calder Cup champion Hershey Bears. Michael Neubert, how about that resume for this young man? Back-to-back Calder Cups. That's a pretty good way to head off to the NHL, isn't it?
Oh, and the way he played tonight, he had to come up, didn't have a whole lot of shots on goal. 22 shots, 22 saves, but he was just unbeatable. He was a wall. That glove hand was as fast and as quick as we've ever seen.
The Calder Cup will be presented shortly. Our Greg Mace is downstairs, and he will have interviews from the ice coming up shortly. The three stars of the game, as we see Brian Helmer grab his children. Mark French at the end of the line. This is just an unbelievable scene here at Giant Center.
The fans don't want to leave. The players don't want to leave. It's the greatest tradition in sports taking place right now. And there's Michael Neubert and Brent Cron as they meet each other and have a few words in center ice and skate away from each other. But this is just the greatest tradition in sports right now, the handshake at the end of the championship.
Mark French, you just saw the head rub from his goaltender. One of the greatest coaching jobs in American Hockey League history this year, and an NHL coach waiting in the wings here in Chocolate Town. 60 wins with the biggest of all shoes to fill, and boy did he do it here in this one. In 60 wins, the Bears, the greatest team in American Hockey League history, the 09-10 Bears. The Bears going back to back. As we go downstairs, Brian Helmer with our Greg Mace. Greg.
Brian, let's talk about the emotions in this moment, because this is such a tight-knit group.
It is. Man, I don't really know what to say. 2 years in a row, these guys have battled their butts off. I love every one of them. It's unbelievable. What a feeling.
And to do it in the way you did it after such a great season, to come back four straight.
Yeah, you know, like I said all along, we believed in each other and we believed in ourselves. And when you got that combination, it's pretty sweet, and we did. I love it.
Congratulations. Brian Helber, team captain. John?
All right, Greg, thank you very much. Downstairs, as they roll out the carpet, and that is what everyone wants to see, as the rink crew brings out the table and the arrival. Not that it really had to go very far, mind you, of the Calder Cup.
Oh.
The symbol of supremacy in the American Hockey League, the Bears, winners in 06 under Bruce Boudreau, winners last year under Bob Woods, and in his first year as head coach, Mark French, an unbelievable job, an unbelievable team that he coached, the defense, the goaltending, the forwards, the most valuable player, of course, in Keith Aucoin, Alexander Giroux with a big goal. This was a team effort every step of the way.
Absolutely, and as it has been throughout the season, it was a four-line team effort where everybody pitched in. And when you're able to roll lines in a game like this for this long, I think that has to say something.
Let's go downstairs. Greg May standing by.
Kyle Wilson, give me some of your emotions.
Oh, no, you still can't believe it. It's one of those things where, you know, you're going in the game, you know you got that chance, but you try and put it out of your mind, and, you know, when it actually happens, it's just a whole weight comes right off of you, and it's tough to describe. It's just as sweet.
You know, the first time in 30 years that somebody's won a cup at home. What about this crowd? This was phenomenal.
Doing it last year was awesome, you know, but on the road, it's just not the same. When you got all your crowds, just, you know, that last 4 minutes was unbelievable. It's, you know, you don't want to celebrate too fast, but the last 4 minutes, they're chanting, "We want the cup," and, you know, just a nonstop noise. It's a great feeling.
Al, thanks. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Al Wilson. John?
Thank you, Greg. As the celebration continues, there's a certain piece of silver hardware that has found its way out to center ice here, Ed, and that is a sight we have not seen here in Hershey for 30 years. Dave Andrews walking out. Let's go downstairs to the president of the American Hockey League.
On behalf of the players from both teams, we want to thank you for your record-breaking support in this Calder Cup playoff. Thank you. Please join me in congratulating the Texas Stars and your fans on the fantastic first season.
Chris Bork, the most valuable player, and a well-deserved one at that. Ed, you and I talked about it. As far as this team went, it was going to be a tough decision on who the MVP was going to be, but Bork ended up leading it in scoring. Obviously, that was big. As the presentation to the captain, Brian Helmer.
And if you can imagine the smile this year being bigger than his smile last year, John.
Brian went 14 years between Calder Cups. He won it in 1995 with the Albany River Rats. As he brings out Keith Aucoin, he brings out Boyd Kane, and cue Tina Turner in-house. The Bears are simply the best.
The entire team now jumping onto the rubber mat in the middle of the ice.
Just a terrific sight as the captain takes a lap with a Calder Cup. For Brian Helmer, an American Hockey League Hall of Famer in waiting. What a way on the backside of his career, 14 years between cups, and then going back to back. This is the presentation. This is what the fans wanted to see. The cup raised in Hershey for the first time in 30 years. Boyd Kane with a handoff to the MVP from Boston, Massachusetts. He's not standing in his father's shadow tonight. Chris Bourque, an unbelievable postseason. The heart and soul, Greg Amadio. Took a puck, or more specifically, a shot to the face in game five. Came back before the end of the period. Alexander Giroux downstairs with Greg.
Well, he's also with his dad, so this has got to be an incredible moment for you.
This is unreal, unreal. My best year in hockey was in Hershey, and that didn't deserve it. This is a great moment for our team. All proud of these guys. We never back down. That was our goal from day one, and we did it. And, my dad was here to see it. This is unreal.
Tell me about your son.
He's terrific. He worked so hard, and he deserved everything he got.
Great crowd, obviously.
Unreal, the best in the league, and it is short tonight, and it's important for us to win in tonight in front of them.
Gee, thanks, Rex.
Thank you.
Alexander Giroux, John.
There is something very moving about father and son on camera. And for Alex's dad to be here and be a part of something like this, words cannot express. Andrew Gordon, what a playoff he had. 14 goals, Ed.
Absolutely, and he was missed when he was out with his lower body injury. When he came back, the spark to the team, and now Greg Mace is downstairs again.
Let's go down with Greg. He's got Chris Bourque, your most valuable player.
Well, Chris, a wonderful series for you. Your dad, Ray, great National Hockey League player, is with us. What does it mean to you to do this again?
It's awesome. I mean, three times in 5 years, you don't see that too often. It's fun to win it at home. It's just a pleasure to be around guys like this. The team's unbelievable. We had an unbelievable year. Perfect way to cap it off.
You did not start the year with us, of course. You were with us, obviously, in the past. Great way to finish.
Yeah, I mean, I came home, and there was one thing to do when I came home is to win a Calder Cup. You know, right from I got here, we started playing unbelievable, and as I said, it's a great group of guys, and like you saw in this series, we fought a lot of adversity, but this team has a lot of, spirit, and it's just unbelievable.
Ray, tell me about what being able to see this moment with Chris means to you.
Well, this is the first time I've seen him win the Calder Cup. This is his third, and he's a champion. It was so much fun to see him win it at home. I've watched it a couple of times on networks, but to see it live here tonight, incredible. He had a great playoff and so much fun. Very proud dad.
Ray, thanks. Chris, congratulations. Most valuable player. Ray Bourque, one of the all-time greats of the National Hockey League, joining his son, celebrating the cup. John.
Greg, seeing Ray Bourque down on the ice was just a fantastic sight in and of itself. He waited such a long time, Ed, for a championship. And to be part of it here tonight, simply incredible.
Absolutely. All these players had goals at the beginning of the year. And now to be carrying the Calder Cup around and lifting it high for the fans in the Giants Center, for the fans in the Giants Center, not only that, but to be compounded by the fact that there are several dads here, proud dads. And how could you be more proud of a son than what we've seen with Alexander Giroux and his dad and with Ray Bourque?
Greg, standing downstairs, Andrew Gordon is there.
Andrew, I know you're great on history of hockey. I know a lot of people put this in historical perspective. The first time in 30 years, these fans have gotten a chance to see you guys win at home.
It's so special to be a part of, and the first one's something you'll remember forever, but this is a totally different experience, and the feeling's not the same, but it's equal. You know, it's a different experience, and I mean, we're here at home with everybody, and not a single fan has left this building yet. The place was rocking all night, and to share this with all these people is something special.
You guys showed great character, getting down 2-0 here, fighting back 4 straight wins, and I thought after it was 3-1, you guys just showed great character.
Yeah, it was. I don't know. I mean, that's just the story of our season kind of thing. Whenever we've had to respond, we have. And this series is no different. All playoffs, we've been doing it. And coming back late in games, scoring in overtime, 9 overtime wins, you don't see that too often. It's something special. This team has to resolve to do anything it wanted. And we were capable of winning this from day one, and I'm glad we achieved that.
Andrew, thanks. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Andrew Gordon. John?
That loud cheer that you just heard was Mark French raising the cup, and now Troy Mann. He didn't get to do this last year, but boy, he's here now, and he's a Calder Cup champion for the first time.
And they both get to kiss the puck, the cup, and everybody in the organization, everybody in the back offices, so to speak, has a chance to hold the puck for a while.
Raising the cup in the air again, the president and general manager, who, by the way, Doug Yingst, this is his 4th Calder Cup. That is tied for the most in American Hockey League history. Let's go downstairs to Greg Mace.
With Keith Acoin, this crowd was unbelievable. And this group of guys has such character. Talk about this team.
Yeah, I mean, the crowd was unbelievable right from the start. And we went right with their enthusiasm right from the start. And they were loud. And we played off of them. And we really wanted to win at home for them. And it's been a special year. And this team has some really good character, and we're just really excited right now.
Keith, thanks. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Keith Acoin. John?
Well, we're back. John Walton, Ed Coffey, high atop the Giant Center, where we get to kind of look at this for the first time as fans, where we're looking at really what is such an emotional moment. This team has been in a beehive. If you can picture a little kids soccer beehive where the kids just want to play together. From the very moment John counted down the end of the third period, this team has come together, and they've been together as one unit since then, where they're just touching each other and handing the Calder Cup to each other the entire time, smiling at each other. They're getting down now for that traditional team picture, too.
Yeah, and all the way to the last beak, the beaker, Dan Stuck, organizing, getting everybody lined up, and there it is. The 2010 Calder Cup champion Hershey Bears. Back-to-back, for the first time in 19 years, the American Hockey League has a repeat champion. 11 Calder Cup titles, 2 better than any team in AHL history. And as pictures are being taken down below, a scene not soon to be forgotten. The family's down taking pictures in behind. This team competed for one another. They cared for one another. They won together. They rarely lost together. And now, as they sit in, pictures now as family members jump in. It is just a terrific scene here.
And the stand's still full.
No one's going anywhere. No one's going anywhere. Not now.
Nobody cares about the traffic leaving the Giant Center, going as everybody goes on whatever their destination is. The East Shore and West Shore of the Harrisburg area. Fans from Reading. There are fans in Martha's Vineyard, Massachusetts tonight that have watched us on television at the Wharf Bar. And this is how far Bears Nation reaches, John.
He's lining up downstairs. We can see Greg Mace with Mark French, and what a job this man has done. Greg, take it away.
Well, what an emotional night.
Yeah, certainly nice to get off to the good start and then, score the next goal to make it 3-0. It was obviously our best game of the series. I thought we committed defensively and offensively. It was probably the most chances that we had. I don't think these guys are going to be denied from the drop of the puck.
You've won it as an assistant coach, now as a head coach. Difference?
No, they're both special, and I think it's special that you win with a lot of the same guys that you won with last year. You know, at this point in time, the players win, and you know, you turn over the dressing room to your leaders, and you got full trust in guys like Brian Helmer, Boyd, Kane, and Keith McCoy, and all the guys just did a great job.
Mark, congratulations.
Thanks, Greg.
All right, Mark French, coach of the Hershey Bears. We'll have some more players, Sean.
Well, you're looking there, for those of you who are from outside the area, you're looking at an NHL coach in waiting right there in Mark French. 60 wins, and it is only as good as what you do in the postseason. It doesn't matter if it's the NHL or you're just starting out in mites. It is how you play. It is whether you win. And obviously, growing up, it is about learning the game. But once you get to this stage, winning is it. And boy, did he do a lot of that this year.
And Mark French approached every game just analytically and knew what he wanted to do, knew what he wanted from his players on the ice and in the locker room. And he had a plan, and the team bought into it. And between Mark French and Troy Mann, because we have to recognize the special teams, John, and how great they were this year, this was an unbeatable team this year.
The Bears and their families are in the shot now. And for a lot of these guys, as good as the first shot is, this one is equally as good. I know that guy. That would be my boy. Jack Walton in the middle of all of that.
Yeah, you're talking about an NHL coach in waiting. With Jack Walton, we have an NHL play-by-play man in waiting.
Well, yeah, I mean, Jack is, I'm just hoping he doesn't want the chair here too soon.
Well, he's been making overtures.
He has indeed, sitting right in the middle of this. The Bears a winner tonight in Game 6 of the Calder Cup Finals, 4-0. They win the Calder Cup 4-2 over the Western Conference champion Texas Stars. I would say well over half of this crowd is still here. They're not going anywhere. But as the celebration continues here and will continue well into tomorrow and the day after that, and probably the rest of the week, this town celebrates Calder Cups like none other, as now Ray Bourque sitting down in this picture as well. Ray Bourque in this team photo. That's a pretty good shot right there. Ray Bourque right in the middle with his son.
This will be a who's who of hockey after the season. I believe Greg Mace is down and ready with someone else to talk to. John.
Greg is standing on to the side. We'll be back down to him in a moment. But is this picture, looking down and seeing Ray Bourque and Jack Walton sitting right next to one another in the middle of that photo, I got to tell you, that's a lump in the throat.
And everybody is saying, who's next to Jack Walton?
Yeah, that's what it'll be.
And look at the pride in Ray Bourque's face as he walks along the blue line. I think he's got to be as happy about his son's Calder Cup as he is about anything else in hockey.
That's true. Let's go downstairs with a real warrior, Greg May, standing by.
Well, a little warrior who was very fired up throughout this game and yesterday. Greg Amadio, talk about your emotions of winning this cup.
You know, it's just a surreal feeling right now. I can't believe it. Back-to-back with just a great group of guys, and having all of our family here and winning at home in front of the Hershey faithful. It's just an unbelievable feeling, and you know, I just can't imagine ending the season any other way now. And
you talk about family, so many family here, and these fans in the stands are like family to this group.
Exactly, yeah, I mean, you know, our family can't be here that often. A lot of us live far away, but the people here support us so much, and you know, obviously without our family, none of us would be here without their support and love, and you know, it's so rewarding to win it in front of them, and you know, I don't think we really realize what's going on right now. We get a chance to sit down and enjoy it. You know, we'll sit back and reflect, but right now we're just going to keep celebrating.
Greg, thanks. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Greg Amadio, John.
Greg, the families on the ice, the players, they don't look like they want to go anywhere either. Rally Towel, Steve Pinizzano, and Alexander Giroux. For those who have not been to a hockey game at Giant Center, or you may not follow the American Hockey League regularly, you don't really grasp what a championship in this town and in this region really mean. And for this team in this town, from Harrisburg to Lebanon to Lancaster to York, Maryland, now D.C., even Northern Virginia, season ticket holders. This means everything to the people who follow this team. And now, as we head back down, Greg May standing by with a proud University of Wisconsin Badger and Andrew Jodry.
Very proud Wisconsin Badger and very proud Hershey Bear just put the hat on me, Andrew Jodry. Talk about this moment for you.
Oh, it's, you know, you want to say it's, last year was great, but this is the best. I mean, to be able to win it at home and to come back the way we did from two down, yeah, I don't know what to say, but you can't stand up with the character in this room. Guys like Brian Helmer, Boyd Kane, and Keith O'Coyne, and Giroux, those guys, they, I'll never forget this. This is one of the most special moments of my whole life.
You had a great start to this game. Came out, fired away. Was the game plan to come out like that?
Yeah, we knew coming home we'd have a lot of great atmosphere and a lot of energy from our fans. And the biggest thing for us in the first was keeping it simple, getting pucks out, getting pucks in. And I think we put them back on their heels a little bit there with you know, a fast-paced start.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All right, here's your hat.
Thank you.
Andrew Jodry, John.
Andrew Jodry downstairs celebrating this one. The Bears are the first team in American Hockey League history for all the records that this team set during the regular year. They are the only team ever to come from two down after losing the first two at home when it looked pretty hopeless after game two. Three on the road. Texas could have even lost a game at home and still won it on home ice. Didn't happen. The Bears won four in a row, capping off the most magnificent season in American Hockey League history.
And they were just thinking after all the other records that they set, John, well, there's one more that we have to. We forgot this one. So let's just take care of this one in the postseason. So they come back and they win the Calder Cup.
Guy that knows something about winning cups, we head downstairs.
Another one for Jay Beagle. Jay, a whole lot sweeter at home, isn't it?
Oh, man, it's... It's I can't even describe words right now with the fans behind us and just how loud it was. You know, winning it in Winnipeg obviously was great, but it doesn't compare to winning at home.
It's a great start for this team tonight to get up 3-0 like that and then just not cruise in, but you certainly had them back on the heels the whole game.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the heart of this team, I mean, we won three on the road and we're a determined bunch. I mean, it's a great feeling.
Jay, thanks.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Jay Beagle, John.
Back up here in press row as we roll on with a Fairview Golf Course post-game show. Greg Mace doing the job for us down below and hearing what these guys have to say about an 11th Calder Cup title. The Bears go back-to-back. It's their third cup in 5 years. After four trips to the finals in 5 years, the Bears, is it too early to talk about three-peat? I don't know. I think it's a little early for that. Celebrating here tonight.
We're wondering how to top what they've just accomplished.
Yeah, I think that's probably setting the bar a little too high. Let's go downstairs. Patty McNeil with Greg.
Well, with two goals tonight, first of all, congratulations. And, boy, you stepped up big time with a couple of great goals tonight.
Yeah, the whole team played great, and you know, I was lucky enough to get two in the back of the net, so I'm pretty happy about that.
Talk about your emotions winning this cup.
It's pretty special, that's for sure. Winning a championship like this is always huge, so it's definitely exciting.
Congratulations, Patrick.
Thank you.
I don't know cheer, if you caught that, no, you're seeing yeah. Laughter there in the background. Doug Yinks just got blasted with champagne by Michael Neubert. Michael, when the focus is on, it's there. But Michael likes to have a good time, too. After being around him for the last couple of years, a tremendous guy. Doug's wife, Sharon, is there. And as he got a blast. Here it is in slow motion, Greg. Michael Neubert blasting the general manager with an entire bottle of champagne. That, in a word that Doug would use, is outstanding.
Yes, it is.
Let's go down to Greg. He's got Michael.
Hey, first of all, one of your best moves of the night was right there, and good work.
Yeah, I mean, that was a great job by everybody, you know. I mean, everyone in the stands could tell we really want to win tonight, and I'm glad we did. And this is an unbelievable feeling, and, you know, in back-to-back Calder Cup champions, that's something special I will never forget.
What about this crowd? What does that do to you guys playing in front of this crowd?
I mean, these fans are unbelievable, you know. They've been here for us, I mean, all year long, and you know, that's not a big reason why we done it.
Another congratulations.
Thank you.
Michael Neuwirth, Sean.
He was the Calder Cup MVP last year. He wasn't the MVP this year, but boy, was he good throughout this postseason and leading this team to back-to-back.
Oh, without a doubt that he was just an anchor back there and a wall, and made sure that he always kept his team in the game. When Michael Neuwirth is playing goal for you, you always have hope. You always know that you have a chance to win. And tonight, even though he wasn't tested extremely often, he had to come up with a couple of big, big saves, John.
Captain America standing by down below with Greg Mace.
Been quite a year for John Carlson with the World Junior Championships up with the Washington Capitals, but put all this in perspective for me.
I don't know, it's tough to put in perspective. You know, it's been a great year for me, I think, and you know, you learn a lot when you're a young guy, and to be on teams with great leaders and just overall great teams, it makes your career a lot easier to jumpstart. It's been a hell of a ride for me, and I can't say enough about the people around me.
Now, it's this crowd chant, Bears, the Bears chant again. This is a very special group of fans. Talk about what that does for you guys, not only tonight, but throughout the year.
Yeah, I think they've stuck with us throughout the year, and, you know, we've broken records at home, and that's huge for us. So, you know, we had the team to do it all year long, and I think that the fans knew it and they sensed it, and, you know, we set a new record this year, so it's obviously a good thing.
John, congratulations.
Thank you.
John Carlson with us. Well, John, we're going to wrap it up, John and Ed, from here. I was there in 1980 and remember the frenzy that went on that night, but this is far beyond anything. A lot of these fans who have been season ticket holders for 20, 30, 40 years have waited for this moment. There are a lot of new fans here in Hershey. This is clearly the best city in the American Hockey League for fans. And tonight they showed it. Tonight they got their wish. The Bears have won their 11th Calder Cup.
Greg, you've done a fantastic job as well. Thank you so much for all your work down below. As we wrap up on the television side, radio continues if you're with us on the Bears Radio Network. But from Hershey, Pennsylvania tonight, it's been the greatest season in American Hockey League history. 60 wins in a regular year, capped off by back-to-back Calder Cup championships. The Bears have sent us into summertime across North America with a 4-0 win over the Texas Stars. For our crew, including Ed Coffey, Greg Mace, this is John Walton. So long from Central PA. The Hershey Bears are Calder Cup champions.